who you are, what your character is, and all that to the party so that everybody knows who everybody is.
My name's
Come on, Duke.
Bosco. I am a sailor druid, and I actually specialize in healing, which is quite convenient since our healer is not feeling so well today and had to step out. So I
Okay.
hope that I can keep y'all alive.
So it's my turn now, right?
Kroll?
Yep, okay. I'm Crow. I'm a half-orc barbarian. I'm an outlander, or I think it was called an outlander. Outcast, outlander, something along those lines. I'm not very liked. Yeah, that's about it, really. I'm gonna be kind of a big, tanky person who's not very bright.
Okay.
Short and sweet, got it. Alright, I'm Lyodin, fighter, dex fighter, dual wielding, very acrobatic, a lot of roguish elements, without actually being a rogue, background of that of a spy. Specialty was a fence, so kind of getting in where I'm not supposed to be, and not getting hit in the first place is kind of how I'm gonna roll things around here. Me and Kroll are blood brothers.
Not yet.
We will.
We'll see.
Okay.
Okay, my name is Zook. I'm a gnome. I'm 3 feet tall. I have the sage background, and I'm a wizard.
The
Wait,
wizard.
you're. Oh, wizard. Okay.
Yes. Master of the arcane.
What are the rules on throwing people?
Oh, there's rules.
Okay.
Fetch people?
What was that, sorry?
What type of people?
Well, I meant, gnomes.
Ah, okay.
Okay, so there's a little flavor text. Red Larch is a town along the road, a few days travel north of Waterdeep and a few days south of Tribor. It's a way stop for caravans coming from the cities of the north. Within the name, with an inn named the Swinging Sword, a tavern called the Helm in High's Sun, and many craftspeople who cater to the travelers that come in and out of there. So there's many places to explore in the town. You guys are basically here because you've heard some rumors of some cultists and some evil happenings around, and you guys decided, just sort of as a group, I'm sort of hand-holding this part of it, that you guys are going to go and find out, what the hell's going on. So as you come into town, that little P token there, that's the party. That's you guys. Just, I'll just move you guys where you want to go. And you guys can decide, where you want to go and what you want to do. And I'll try and give you a little more information so that you're not just completely blind at this point. But that's the part of the friggin' thing that I lost that I can't seem to find already to dig up. Because as a DM, some of you might have DM'd before, one of you I think did, but this thing starts in chapter 6. It's not like you just open the module and it's like, no, step one, you gotta go and it starts at level 3, and it says if you have level 1 character, you gotta go way down to chapter 6 and start here. It's all friggin' confusing. It's crazy. So I'm digging for that.
Since we're
While
looking for
he's
cultists, should we go to the tavern or do you think the church to see what the locals would know? I think the tavern is the best place to gather
Yeah,
information.
I agree.
Okay, so right now what you guys can see is the building to your immediate north is the All Faith's Shrine. The one to your south is the poultry shop. The one across the way to the south is the Wagon Works, and then the one on the northeast corner is the clothier. But there's a couple people in the street there that are walking by. So if you were to say, "Hey, you know, which way is the Swinging Sword Tavern or whatever?" They say, "Oh, it's right up there." So I'll open this map a little and show you guys where that is. So you guys go around the corner here, and that's pretty much it right there on the left. So, one door north of the shrine stands a Swinging Sword. The inn is a three-story stone structure crowded by a steep slate roof that bristles in with many chimneys. My eyes are freaking out, so if you're reading along with me and I say the words wrong, that's just because my eyes are freaking out. A signboard just over the door, hanging from the chains. It's a 10-foot-long carved wooden scimitar emblazoned with the inn's name and red paint on both sides. An inn yard with stables and outbuildings lies behind the building.
That's funny, because that ding, like, I was imagining us, like, swinging open the door and, like, a little bell chime.
Yeah, it's like Radio Shack used to be.
Free ale for everyone.
Okay, so this place looks like welcoming and luxurious and has like rustic standards, and do you guys want to go in? I'm assuming you do.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I say we go in, yeah. Get a table and just keep our ears open.
Okay, so you guys can go in and sit down and maybe order a couple of drinks. Go ahead.
I was going to say, I'll go up to the bartender and ask if he's heard anything about the cultists in the area.
Okay. You walk up to the bartender and he's like, "Yeah, I don't know much about that stuff. I just serve the drinks, but she does." And he points to a lady, and I'll give you her name.
Tavern Wench.
Her name is Tavern Wench. No, it's not.
Oh, okay.
No, it's not. Oh, so you have to... Wow, I don't know why this won't copy. That didn't work either. There we go. That's her name. So, what is this? Why am I getting a ding? That's funny. That's my text messaging. Okay, so she's over there.
Wow.
And let me tell you about this. Tell you about her anyway. Okay, so she's friendly. She's the friendly type, and she sits down. She says, "Hi, yeah, welcome to town," you know, that kind of thing. Kind of just mixed pleasantries amongst you guys, and she's a big believer in every monster that's slain makes Red Larch that much safer. And she's a little she starts regaling you with a couple stories of how she's heard about bad things in the area, and she gets real happy when that gets taken care of. And she tells you of recent disturbances near Red Larch. She's heard many tales about fogs that persist in the Sumber Hills, and even in bright sunlight there'll be this fog and sudden gusts of hot winds. What happened?
Ravenloft.
Oh, yeah, Ravenloft. Count Strahd. Don't get worried. Don't panic. She continues on and on about the colds and the fogs and all this kind of stuff. And she says there's been a lot of violent sights too, such as sudden bolts of lightning stabbing up from the hills to clear the sky. Fell magic, she calls it. And though she admits this was an opinion shared with her, she sees more. She's seen none of this herself. This is all just like hearsay. She also noticed some red larchers looking both frightened and furtive, and so
she's kind of like a meteorologist, right?
She's the local weather girl.
Fog, lightning.
So
probably the local something else too.
Yeah. So, what do you guys want to ask her or talk to her about?
Where are these disturbances coming from?
She says, "Well, you know, I have a theory about that. It's all related to an evil presence at Lance Rock. Neither the constable nor the town elders will help me with this. But if you guys will go investigate this disturbance at Lance Rock and make sure no sinister forces are lurking there, I'll give you 50 gold.
She will?
Yeah, she says she'll give you 50 gold if you go investigate this.
That's a pretty wealthy tavern wench.
I was only joking. She's not the tavern wench. She's an adventurer.
Oh. That makes a lot more sense.
Yeah, sorry. One of my comedy things is whenever somebody says something that seems ridiculous, I repeat it as if it's the truth, and I've been doing that so far. I've done it like 4 times with you guys. So I'll try to make clear what
Thanks
I'm joking
for
about.
Us now.
Yeah, right. So like when somebody says, "Is she kind of a meteorologist?" I said, "Yeah, she's the local weather girl." That I'm assuming that you guys obviously knew I was joking, but I'll try to be more clear about what I'm joking about. So, she is an adventurer, but everything she said is all part of, that's all the truth. So, what do you guys think?
Where is Lance Rock, actually?
Okay, fair question. One second. If only I friggin' had. Okay, so I'm gonna send you guys a map here in a second. So,
it's right here.
you guys are there in Red Larch, and she tells you that Lance Rock is just up the way, and if this thing will reveal like it's supposed to. There we go. It's just up there to the you guys can see it, right?
Yep.
Okay, so she says, "Yeah, if you guys will go up there, then I'll give you 50 gold if you guys will go up there and make sure there's no shenanigans."
50 gold apiece?
50 gold. So that'd be
Come on.
I like it.
Oh, you guys don't want to do that? Okay. Maybe I can find some other adventurers, so...
Well, I mean, we already know where Lance Rock is, so maybe you can.
Is 50 gold much in this world, by the way?
For a first-level character, how much did you start with?
Fair point.
10?
And so, more than doubling your money, would that be of interest to you?
Yes.
Definitely.
Okay, there you go.
Fine.
Nice.
No, but don't worry. Soon enough, you guys will save up to buy a 40,000 gold piece galley and set out on the high seas. Don't worry.
Wait, that's
Are we
part
the
of this
first
campaign?
to...
Balls is not going to be the captain.
That was a joke, by the way.
Is there any other local monsters that we should know about that live around that area?
Oh, you're asking the girl?
Yes.
She says only what I've heard, that there's been some terrible things, but that's kind of why I want you guys to go up there. I want you to make sure that place is safe and check it out for me. I don't know specifically of any monsters, but that's kind of why I'm paying you to go look.
So how far is it? How far is Lance Rock from here?
Oh, that's, let me give you the scale, too. That's a good idea. Each hex, I think, is 10 miles.
Jesus.
What sort of terrain is it?
Let me get to that here. Let me just make sure I can fix this thing.
I was going to say, if that's 10 miles, man, it's going to take us a couple days to get there.
Yeah, that takes
more
than that.
Something from the stables, though, right?
It's also depending on the terrain, if there's a road or something, or if you have to go through the woods, basically.
Yeah. We can take the path, like, halfway there and then just cut over.
Through the woods.
There you
Wasn't
go.
There a stables, though? Couldn't we, like, rent horses?
One hex is 2 miles, so we're talking about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're talking about a 12-mile march. You don't need horses.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's not too bad. I mean, that would take all day, but you could do it in a day.
Right. So you guys, assumedly what you guys would do if you want to head out there is...
We should provision first.
Yeah, you should make sure that you're ready to go. I know there was a couple
characters. Yeah, is there anything you
want to
buy?
Yeah, is anything we want to buy? We can take care of that, because there's definitely places in town here that you can go and do that.
Yeah, and I want to buy a bedroll.
A bedroll? Okay, so let me find out.
Yeah, I've got plenty of rations and torches, so I'm pretty much ready to go.
Okay, yeah, let me find out where the... actually, there's no reason. This town is pretty open, so the map of Red Larch, I'm just going to open that whole thing up, because there's no reason to really, hide it from you. There's no, like, secret places or anything like that. Yeah, if I can learn how to do it, I'll do it.
Hey, Rob, got a logistics question for you.
Sure.
I know every DM is different, so how do you do character weight and encumbrance?
I don't worry about it. It's a variant rule, and I don't use any of the variant rules. So the only thing I would say is don't get crazy and think you're going to carry around like 200 pounds worth of stuff, but. As long as it's not too crazy, I'm not going to worry about it.
Gotcha.
Is there any equipment thing you can buy, like, animals and stuff? How does that work?
Right, but we're not going to get into that at this point anyway.
Okay, but could eventually, is there in the Pathfinder one, you could buy a dog? Like a guard dog? Can you get, pets and things like that?
Yeah, in this we're not doing that.
Ah, okay.
So you guys on your Red Larch map, you should be able to see the whole thing at this point.
Yep.
Okay, so let me find out which one is the gal that you were talking to. She'll tell you where the local merchant is that you can go and get the bedroll and anything else you guys want to take care of. And as soon as I find it, I will send you. I'll move the P down there so you guys can see where you are.
I'm asking the guys, should we get a tent as well, or?
If we get what as well? Oh, a tent?
A tent, yeah.
Yeah, if somebody might have a tent.
Has someone want a tent?
I think I might get one. Oh no, just a bedroll.
Yeah. I do have a tent, and one tent sleeps two people.
Okay, so someone else might want to get a tent if you guys want to do that.
Yeah, I can't carry it, so someone else should get it.
Yeah, everybody's got an 8
it's
strength.
Bigger than he is.
I'm already encumbered with all the stuff I get from the starting pack.
Give me the tent. I've got enough strength, I'm sure.
Yeah, then I will buy a tent and a bedroll. And I hand the tent to... was it Bosco?
No, Kroll, right?
To Kroll, okay.
By the way, does time spent matter at all?
Time spent in what regard?
Like with travel and stuff like that. Does that?
Oh yeah, it matters. I mean, it yeah, it matters.
Because I'm an outlander, so I think I get like I'm better with maps and things like that. Does that mean I could find like a shorter route there?
No, but you can find food and stuff. You don't need rations.
You guys are... I appreciate everybody's enthusiasm and you know, trying to come up with ideas about how to do things certain ways or make things easier or whatever. But usually the best way to do it is if I need you to be creative in some way, I'll ask you guys, like, how do you want to handle that? Or do you guys want to do anything special? But if... In most cases, like if I say, oh, it's over there and it's, you know, it's a 12-mile march and you guys go there and I don't alter that in any way, you guys should just take that as your cue to take the freebie and go there without problems. Now, if I say, you know, it's a thick woods and, you know, it's like 6 inches between all the trees and, you know, how do you think you're going to get through that or some crazy thing like that, I'll ask you guys about it. But if I don't say anything, you
right,
guys should just
okay.
take that as your cue to, you know, just be glad I'm not killing you already.
What things were meant to work out and which things we're meant to just ignore.
Right. Yeah, so a lot of that will just come as we play and you'll learn. But but it's always fine to ask me. That's never a problem. Okay, so, So you guys need to go to the local merchant who is... I'll show you where he is if I can get my damn map back. God damn thing. Okay.
Is that a quarry to the north of the...
It is a quarry, actually, yes.
Okay.
Okay, so you guys need to go to... Ah, there he is. Okay, so you guys come down here to the south, and you're going to be at a place called Villavo's Sundries. And if you go... no one has sent me a text message, so I can't do the door sound, but ding ding, you guys walk in there. Down there. And... there's a little flavor text. Aside from the bewildering profusion of doors, barrels, and rotting old furniture and tools leaning against its outside walls, this building looks like a private home. A small faded sign on the front door reads, Villavo's Sundries. Rooms are crammed to the rafters with new wares and used items of all sorts. So you guys are able to go in there, and anything that you want to buy, any equipment, your bedroll, your tent, and all this kind of stuff, we can take care of here. Also in there is Endrith Villavo. He's the proprietor. You guys can talk to him if you want. And he, as you walk in, he's, you know, he's, hail, greetings, and well met, travelers. How may I help you?
Hello, sir. I would like to buy a bedroll.
Ah, bedroll, a fine piece of equipment for outdoor adventuring. Absolutely, we have a few of those here. And he, you know, reaches down under the counter. He's actually got one ready, puts it up there and says, that'll be, and he shouts out the price of the, I don't have it in front of me, but whatever the normal price is what he says that'll be.
Yeah, I will take it.
Okay, what is the price for that? Does anybody know?
He checks the book, I don't know.
It's a gold piece.
Okay.
Okay, I give him a gold piece.
Okay, so at this point, everybody has one. I see that there's 4 bedrolls in the party. Each person has one, yeah?
I just added one.
Okay, cool. So you take off a gold and you're fine.
Yeah, and I ask him, do you sell tents also?
A tent. Ooh, yes, a specialty item, but I do happen to have one left in the back. I have a two-person tent back in the back. I'd be happy to
How
sell
much
you
is
that.
it?
I will
It's
tell
two.
you. It's 2 gold pieces.
Do we split that crew?
I've already bought a healing kit. That was 5 gold, man. I'm pretty hurt right now. So
You pay
I'm
for it, I'll
asking
carry
crew.
it if you let me share it.
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, so you guys will have 2 tents now, so.
The half orc and the gnome are gonna be sleeping together. That's cute.
Yeah. At least you
It's
can
more
sleep the
room
same
efficient
night.
that way.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I get more legroom.
Okay, so go ahead and add a tent to your thing and then take off 2 gold.
No, one each.
No.
Oh.
No, you're paying. I carry it.
Wait,
That's a fair
okay.
deal.
It's fine.
I
Carry
mean,
the
you
tent or
can't
the
carry
gnome?
it. Both.
You're gonna carry him as well.
Hodor.
You guys might be moving slow. Okay, so yeah,
Pay for
that was
everything.
the deal. He's gonna carry it, you're gonna buy it. Is that the deal?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So go ahead and add that and then take off your 2 gold.
I
Let's
did.
see. What else? I don't see the tent in the party. I only see one tent
I've got
in
it.
the party.
Cruel needs to add it because I paid it, and or should I add it in my inventory because I paid it? I don't know.
Well, actually, I believe there's another way to do that. Rob, correct me if I'm wrong, but there should be a party treasure section where people can drop things into it, and then they can take it or give it to other people.
Right. Yeah, there is. If you guys open up your party sheet, top right icon in the entire screen, and look in inventory, you should see your inventory, I think, and then you can drop stuff up in the upper window. Is that true? Can you guys do that?
I don't know where.
Okay, upper right icon in the entire game, the eye with the three little people by it, it's called party sheet.
Got it.
Open that and then go to the inventory tab.
Yeah.
Got it.
And can you see your inventory?
Yes, I see everyone's inventory,
Yeah, we can see
basically.
everybody's
Oh, you
inventory.
can see everybody's inventory. Well, isn't that special? Okay, so in that case, whoever has the tent that wants to give it to somebody else, drag it up to the top and drop it in there, and then the other person can take it.
Oh, I've already got it in my inventory, though.
That's good.
Okay, well, so at this point, I see that Liadin has a tent. I don't see that anyone else has a tent.
Crew, I should have one. It's right near the bomb.
Okay, what's your character's name again?
Crew.
Right, I still haven't got the voices down. Tent. Yes, you do have it. Why isn't it on the.
Because he probably typed it in. I'm not sure if he dragged
No,
it.
No,
dragged it from
I
the
didn't
module.
realize it. There's actually a refresh key on the thing, which I assumed it would have. Most stuff in Fantasy Ground, you drag it or you change it, and it changes everywhere. But there is a refresh key that I didn't see until now. So yes, I do see
Where's
two
that
tents.
refresh key?
Well, you might not have it, but I see the entire party's inventory, and it there right next to it. There's a
Oh.
rebuild party inventory key, is what I have.
Yeah, I think when you refreshed it, it refreshed it for me too, because as soon as you
Same.
said that, it popped in.
Yeah, for me
Okay.
too.
Okay,
And
For
yeah.
everyone.
so great. So everybody, so and the proper person, did the person who buy the tent have it, or did the person who is carrying the tent have it?
It's a person who was carrying it, has it?
Okay,
I
great.
just deducted the gold.
Okay, fantastic. So we're good to go there. Awesome. I think tent buyer and tent carrier, give yourself inspiration.
Thanks.
Yay.
How do I do that?
Sorry.
The
Any
little thing in the
page
top
of
right that
your
says insp.
any page of your character sheet, there you go. Clickety click. Everybody's got stars except for Bosco. We'll find a reason for him to get one eventually. Okay, so you guys are talking with Endrith, you bought your stuff. Does anybody need to buy anything else?
Is it worth getting a map of the area?
You've got one.
Oh, we have? Okay, never
Well,
mind.
In other words, I've hidden the map of the area except for what you know, but let's just see. That's a great question, and I'm a DM who will roll with punches, so let's do this. Let's see the percent chance that he's got a map of the area.
How come I don't see any gold stars for Zook or Cruel?
You only see yours. You don't see us's.
Oh,
Okay.
right. Okay, so that's good. Because I see all three. Okay, so there's a 78% chance he's got a map. So who asked for the map? Okay, so Cruel, go ahead and roll a D100. Do you know how to do that?
This one.
No,
Right?
that's a that okay,
Oh, that's.
here's what you do. On the 10-sided die, right click it and you'll see percentage. Choose that and then roll.
This gotta work out which one the 10-sided die is.
Yeah, the third
Second
one,
one, no?
from the left.
Ah, okay. And then, what was it?
Choose percentage, which will roll that's a 1D100. 22. He does have a map of the area. And he will sell
Oh.
you that map for
That Cruel
five.
can't read.
It is a specialty map that he hand drew, and he will sell that to you for 5 gold.
Is there anything special about the map?
It's not special. It's just that it took him a long time to make. And so
Ah, okay.
if you want to, basically what I'm saying to you is the map of the area that it shows Red Larch in that. For 5 gold, I'll open the whole thing up now so you can see it all.
Yeah, I'll do that then. I'll buy the map.
Okay, so take 5 gold off your character sheet and I will open the map.
One question for you, Rob.
Yes.
I want to cast this familiar spell. Do I do that now or when we do the first camp?
How long does it last? It lasts, it takes an
It
hour, but
lasts forever.
it lasts until the thing goes away, right? Okay, so it takes an hour to do it, so I would say you would cast that when you guys like settle into a camp or whatever. That'd be a good time to do it.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So let me get this map squared away here. Not that one. There's 30 maps on my screen. There's not 30, but there's a few. No. Guy should DM a game one day so you can know my hell. But
And then kind of have to let
hell,
other people do it.
it's fun. It's fun. I'm having fun.
I hope you have two screens to make it a bit better.
That's the thing. I don't have 2 screens. I'm literally have a laptop and it is on my lap. I'm sitting in a chair with a laptop on my
Whoa, it's hard. You need to get a
lap.
screen.
Do you at least have a mouse?
Oh yeah, I got a mouse.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's on the arm of the chair.
You should put a donation thing on Twitch for a screen.
I do have that, and I do have that on there, but we'll see if
Cool.
anybody. Okay, so let's see. Here I've got all the maps and stuff. Let me find it.
Here we go.
Wonder where the hell that went all of a sudden. Okay, you talk to her. Let's just see. I gotta go. I'm sorry, guys. There's literally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's 7 open windows and 3 icons on my thing, and none of them are what I need.
Oh.
Always.
So I'm kind of just backtracking through.
Hey, does anybody have a set of dice? And want to make some money?
I got a playing card set.
You want to play cards?
How dare you?
Sure.
I'll play you for 1 gold. Is that a no?
Oh, what was that?
Well, do you want to play for 1 gold? I'm not sure why you're laughing at this.
Okay, kinda... so here we go. And Kroll bought the map, is that right?
Yep.
I mean, I can't even handle 2 maps.
Well, I wonder why this doesn't work now. I have the map, so I'm just trying to give it to you.
We got it, or? I can see it.
Oh, you, see, I didn't mean to do that. I meant to, what I was going to do is I was going to give it just to him.
Okay.
Then make you guys come up with the idea, like, hey, can I see that map? And then I would open it, but I just opened it for everybody, didn't I?
Well, people
can close it.
Well, whatever. Okay, so I need to, this will increase my DM skills. I need to learn how to do that. Okay, so now you guys have basically can see the whole surrounding areas, but at this point, Lance Rock up there to the left is where you need to go. Are you guys all full up on equipment?
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with what I've got.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's that. Let me see if he says anything else here. Okay, so he says, thank you, gentlemen. All purchases are final, but I always keep my customers happy, so if you have problems, you let me know and we'll work something out. And he says, and I don't know if this is relevant, but I overheard someone say that they saw a skull pinned to a tree with a black arrow, like some kind of dire warning or an ill omen or something like that. And it was half a day's walk along the larch path, and then about 4 miles east into the hills.
Could you mark that on the map for me?
I could mark that on the map.
Thank you.
I closed the map. Can I open it somehow again?
Yes. Go to your images and maps, and it should be in there. It's called Red Larch Surroundings.
Hey, Rob.
Yeah.
If you had to associate an ability with playing cards, which one do you think it would be?
Playing cards ability, I think, would be performance.
No, so like ability score wise.
Charisma. It depends. Are you trying to play a? Are you trying to do card tricks? Because that would be sleight of hand. Are you trying to just play poker or, go fish with somebody and have a personal interaction? It depends.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was going for, like actually playing a card game like poker or something like that.
So it really depends. It would, if you were playing poker with somebody and you wanted to cheat or you wanted to pull a trick or you want, it really, I mean, it could be almost anything. It just depends on the actual thing that happens. There's no real good way to answer unless it's something really super specific, like what is it when you jump off a cliff? And even then, that could be acrobatics, or it could be strength, or it could be athletics. You never know unless, you know what I mean? You can't really pre-plan, like, what skills are going to be used for what. And if you do pre-plan it, the DM's going to throw a change at you like, oh, so you thought you were going to get away with using your arcana on that, huh? Well, no, it's history. You know what I mean? It's going to be... So you can't really pre-plan stuff.
Yeah, I got you. It's just in the actual playing card set, when you read it, it says, if you're proficient with a gaming set, you can add your proficiency bonus to ability checks you make to play a game with that set.
Right.
Each type of gaming set requires a separate proficiency.
Right. Okay. So, like, yeah, if you're proficient with dice and you had a dice set and you were going to play something and do something with dice and I was asking you to make checks, you could add, you know, your plus two to that check for that, no matter what kind of check it was. Yeah. Okay, so on the Red Larch surrounding maps, I kind of... Unfortunately, the DM has the choice and only choice of black to draw with. So I kind of drew circles around the X where it says the last laugh. Do you guys see that?
Okay. Nope.
You don't see it?
If you got a wheel on your mouse, when you go over the map, you can scroll in and out to make the map bigger and smaller, and that might help you a lot.
Yeah.
No, on my map, only the pass. It's lit. Everything else is dark.
Might have to reshare it.
There you go.
Yeah, now it works.
Okay, so the last laugh X is what he's talking about. So that's two places now that you've heard about that might be worth investigating. But you guys were just about ready to head out to the...
Lansrock.
Right. He in no way offers you money or says anything that he'll give you a reward or anything. He just tells you, hey man, in case you guys want to know, I heard this rumor about this, you know, skull being pinned to a tree and whatnot.
Okay. I would say we head for Lansrock.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. Let's stick with plan idea. A.
Gets us choosy 50 gold.
Choosy 50 gold. Okay. So you guys, can't pass up cash, right? So you guys head out toward Lansrock. You got all your supplies. Assumedly, you would drop by the the inn one last time. And we'll say it's midday at this point. So, matter of fact, let's get a time check here. We'll call it 11:20 a.m. And so you guys, assumedly you'd have a nice strong lunch there and at the end, and you could probably get she'll hook you up because she is the one the lady you were talking to is sending you off to go adventuring, so she will hook you up with a free lunch before you go. And so we'll say it takes you the rest of the day to hike up toward Lansrock, and then you guys can make camp there at night. By the way, just to let everyone know, the stuff that goes through the chat window and all you guys are talking in there and doing stuff, that's absolutely awesome and great. But don't count on me looking at anything unless I'm specifically interacting with you in there. Or if we're making rolls and stuff in there, I tend to not look at that because it just goes by. It goes by. It's like the Twitch chat. I don't look at that either.
Doing it to not interrupt you, though.
Yeah, no, that's exactly. Fine. That's absolutely what that's for. And so, but I just want you guys to know that if you need me to know something, you should say it rather than type it. Okay. So you guys are out there, and you guys can make camp. And let's see. Lansrock is a narrow 25-foot menhir of bare gray rock that juts eastward at a 60-degree angle. I don't know what a menhir is, but that's what it is.
This is like the Grand Canyon or something.
Okay.
Menhir, maybe?
Menhir, yeah. It says it's gray granite, unlike the surrounding limestone, and it looks like it was... put here, like it's definitely not a natural phenomena. And there's a ravine a few hundred feet south, and choked with brush and stuff, and a trail leads into the brush near the painted sign, and the sign reads in common, "Come no closer, lest you catch the disfiguring plague that afflicts me." I don't know why the sign has a weird voice. The Lord of Lancerock.
I'm sure it's nothing to worry about.
So there's a cave. There's a cave up ahead.
Are there any tracks? Can I do a check, or can someone who is good in nature do a check?
Anyone? Let's see. Where's my list? Where's my list? Anyone who wants to check for, since you said it, you can check. That's kind of how that works. I would do a nature check.
Yeah, I suck at this.
So just go ahead and roll a nature check on your character sheet.
One second.
No problem, because I'm looking for something anyway, so take your time. Ooh, okay, 17, so let me find the answer to that.
Sorry, what were you checking for?
Tracks.
Yeah, he's looking for tracks.
Okay. I mean, I'm pretty good in survival, so might be worth me doing it as well.
Yeah, that's why I asked.
You do see tracks, but they just look normal. But they lead right up to the cave, and you can tell that there's, more than one person, but you're unable to determine like how many people. It just looks like normal footpath kind of traffic, but it goes right up to the entrance of this cave.
Yeah, I tell everyone what I found out. We should be prepared if we go in the cave.
It's not dark outside yet, right? I mean, it's still.
Well, no, you guys. I forget. Did we say we already made camp, or did you? Yeah, because we would have to. It's getting to be night, basically, right now. We'll say it's a. You guys hiked up there. It was 12 miles. We'll say that took.
So, do y'all want to go ahead and search the cave now, or do y'all want to make camp for the night?
I guess it doesn't really make sense. Should we camp and go in tomorrow morning?
Well, it's not going to be much brighter in there in the day, is it?
Yeah, that's true. I would like to prefer one spell.
Okay, so yeah, you can cast your familiar now, and then I would say normally what you guys might do is it's like 9:20 at night, so you guys don't have to take a rest now, but you can if you want. Now I will tell you as the dungeon master, if you guys take a long rest, there is a chance that something will disturb you in the night, but it might not happen. So it's up to you guys what you want to do.
Well, here's my thoughts on this. If we make camp, one, that would give the druid and the wizard time to prepare spells for going into caves. Two, it would give us a chance to observe the cave in the cover of darkness.
That's a good point. We should set up watches.
So, yeah. I'm sorry, I thought what I heard was go in and then set up watches. Which one's it going to be?
I guess we'll camp then.
I vote to the camp.
Same.
Okay, sounds good.
I'm going to cast my familiar spell now.
Okay, that's good. That way, you'll cast it. It'll take you an hour to do it, but then you will rest and you'll be able to get it back.
Hey Rob, how do you make the a vote in chat?
Oh, it's slash vote and then space whatever you want to say about it.
Exactly. Yeah.
No, I guess I kind of have to then. Gonna keep the illusion of choice here.
Right. Now, like, obviously, we're not gonna camp, like, right in front of it. But you said you wanted to watch the cave entrance, is that right?
Yeah, to see if we see anybody coming, going, anything like that. Lights coming from inside, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Are we able to split up so I go and like sit outside the cave a little bit in the trees?
I'm gonna give you a map of what you guys, where you guys are, so you can kind of tell exactly what's going on here. I'm just preparing it.
Okay.
Thank you. For that spell, there is nothing to click, so I assume it is a success automatically.
For
The
the find familiar.
familiar, yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me show you where you guys are at this point. It should be loading a map for you.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it
It's
is.
loading.
Yeah, it takes a minute. Some of those ones that showed up really fast earlier, I had preloaded on your guys' thing, so like loading in the background. But this
Ah,
one,
okay.
I didn't know which way you guys were going to go, so it ended up being this, and so that'll happen a lot, is the map won't
Oh, so
actually
we
be.
could have gone to any of the places on the other map.
Well, no. There was just a couple ways you could have gone. Like that guy told you about the skull being pinned to the tree, so you could
The
have gone
last
that way.
lap.
But it was you just kind of you guys already had decided to go this way. So I'm just saying that I
Right,
didn't
okay.
prior to starting today, I didn't know which maps to pre-download and all that.
Okay, so if we had gone to the church, we could have ended up somewhere totally different,
Exactly.
or. Oh, that's cool.
Oh, cool.
Okay, so I'm putting you guys on the map, but don't worry about the size for we'll fix the size here.
Do I get a little window with the stats of my family, or?
Yeah, that's the thing. We gotta come up with a little thing for that. So hold on just a second. Let's see. Actually, what you can do is what familiar did you give yourself?
A raven.
Okay, so you can go into the player's handbook and go under NPCs and grab the raven and get his stat block. And I'll have to put one in the combat tracker for you too as well.
Oh, so we could actually use the raven for scouting then.
Yeah,
Yeah, that's why I
exactly.
picked the raven.
Send it
Oh,
into
that's
the
cool.
cave, it doesn't come back.
Well, that's cool. I can also see the stats. It's pretty sweet.
Yeah. Okay, so do you guys all see yourselves on the map? It's really you gotta zoom in kind of because it's really small. This map is a pretty big map, but each square is 5 feet.
You might have to scroll down a little bit. It's right in the bottom left corner.
Yeah, bottom left corner, and then you can, if your mouse is on top of your token, that yellow arrow will scroll around, and that's your facing. That's just which way you're facing.
Right.
And when you're next to each other like that, it'll kind of be hard to see, like the arrow might go under a guy or whatever. But just go ahead and. Let's see. Yeah, each one of those is 5 feet, so that's how small that is. It's pretty small scale, but it's a big map. So you guys are,
Wow.
but if you scroll all the way out, if you just right wheel or your mouse wheel back toward you, it'll scroll out the whole size of the map, and then that yellow thing in the bottom right corner of the map is how you kind of scroll through the map. And if you want
you
to,
can just right-click it.
A good place to start is if you right-click just any open space on the map and choose resize, which is the double window, and then choose adjust horizontal, it'll shrink that whole thing down so that you have a whole window with the entire map in it, and then from there you can manipulate it how you want because it just makes it easier.
Ah, brilliant. So whereabouts is the cave in relation to us?
Yes, I was just getting that.
Okay. Sorry if all the questions get a little bit more. I'm aware that they might be kind of slowing us down a bit.
No, not at all. Don't worry about the questions at all. Okay, so you guys don't necessarily want to approach there yet, because I think you're going to make camp here.
Yes.
But we'll say that you guys camp here, and then let's do this. Let's go to the party sheet. Again, the upper right icon in the entire game, and then click on the order. And we'll set the watch order. So decide who wants to go. Nobody's an elf, are they?
No.
Okay, so everybody has to go to sleep. So, you guys just decide amongst yourself who wants to take first watch, second watch, third watch, fourth watch, that kind of thing.
I would recommend that people with night vision do the second and third, and the other ones the first and last, because there's a little bit daylight left.
All right, well, I'll go third then.
Okay, so just can you guys put your own numbers in those numbers, or do I have to do it?
I can't.
You can't do it?
I think you have to.
Okay, so Krull, what number are you going to do?
I'll do 3.
And Lyadin?
I'll take this watch.
And Zook?
2nd.
Oh my god.
And that leaves...
Yeah,
boss, go for last.
Sense for you to go last since you've got dark vision.
That's not going to make too much difference.
Okay,
so...
I assume first you have, like, the sun is going down and last the sun is going up, so the two in the middle are where, like, no sun is.
Oh yeah, that makes more sense.
Okay, so... As you guys settle in for the night...
Or Zook could just cast Alarm as a ritual and go to sleep.
I don't have that spell.
Aww.
You are the worst wizard.
You're the worst. Okay, so you guys go to sleep, and on first watch, I'll roll to see if there's any shenanigans in the... in the night. First watch goes by uneventful. Ooh, second watch goes by uneventful. Third watch, nothing happens.
Well, that was anticlimactic.
Fourth watch, you're all dead. No, nothing happened. So you guys made it through the night. You got a lucky night. So you guys wake up in the morning. Let's see. Try to get the calendar all the time. I keep opening the color bar. That's not what I want. So we'll say it's about... some kind of almost 7 o'clock in the morning. And you guys at this time would probably need to eat. So, on your character sheets.
But we have a ranger, huh?
Everybody has... 3 people have 10 rations. What does Zook have to eat?
I don't have rations.
Uh-oh. What do you...
I'll give you one. I'll give him one.
Okay, so
I'll take off two.
Bosco take off two, and Lyadin and Curl take off one ration.
All right. Do you get is that like a well-rested bonus or something for eating more?
No, it's just that if you don't eat, I like to play it as real as possible. So if you didn't eat, you might start to suffer exhaustion or some other bad thing might happen to you. And Lyadin, did you take off a ration?
Yeah, I just did.
Okay, cool.
Well, actually, I guess it's a bit late now, but couldn't I have scavenged some food?
That's what I mean.
Yes, but that would have taken time.
Okay.
So next time you can do that if you want. I mean, if you want to get into all that, we can do that. Certainly. Anything you guys want. I'm the yes DM. You can do anything you want. It's just like, when you do that, what's going to happen? Okay, so cool. Tracking. So you guys wake up. So you know that you're interested in heading toward the cave. So when you look over there, without even going over there, just when you look over there, you see that the cave mouth opens into darkness from which a breeze blows, carrying the faint odor of death. Oh my god, oh, that's good. Not ominous. Inside the natural cave, its floor, ceiling, and uneven, the passage leads to the west, narrowing as it proceeds. So, let's see. Do you guys want to go and approach over there?
Oh yeah.
Let's go for the trees.
Should go stealth.
Something about spells, what was that?
No.
You said like stealth.
Stealth, hiding.
Like, oh, stealth, okay.
Travel through the trees or something.
Yeah.
Well, I am definitely not stealthy, so I would need y'all to stealth all the way up there, and then when it's clear, I'll follow you.
You know, that being said, I don't think I'm too stealthy either.
Those of you who would like to attempt to stealth, go ahead and give me a stealth roll in the window, in the chat.
Do you just walk up to it with me?
Can I do it with disadvantage?
For what reason?
Because it's rocky terrain and I get advantage for that. You can look in my character sheet.
You get stealth checks at an advantage?
Yes. It's stone camouflage.
Okay, cool. I wonder if that's automatic. Roll a stealth check, and if it's not automatic, I'll give you another one.
How the hell is the half-orc stealthier than me right now?
Well, should me and you just woke up the
It didn't lose that advantage.
Okay, so go ahead and roll another one. Around.
Yeah, okay. Well.
So we got a 7. We got a 7, a 12, a 10, and who didn't go?
Balls.
Yeah, because I'm not stealthy.
So right now I'm the stealthiest.
But I mean,
here.
I'll do it. Okay. Oh my god, I am the stealthiest.
Wow.
I'm the stealthiest, motherfucker.
So the dude who shouldn't have any business being stealthy is has done pretty well. But the rest of you are clinking and clanking all over the place, tripping on rocks and doing shit like that. So you're not going to be that quiet.
Snapping twigs and rolls over here.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Okay, can I send my raven to scout?
You can.
Okay.
And that is not going to be something that I will hand wave and just make it easy all the time. Your raven might get swallowed by a black hole somewhere or whatever. So just be aware of that. But I'm not going to do that unnecessarily. I'm just saying that, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, you know what we need to do? I need to give you the raven. He needs to be put on the thing, so let me get in there and do that.
The yellow arrow is where we're looking, or...?
Correct.
Oh, no. Oh, okay, so in the combat tracker, the raven is in there, and I will set him to friendly.
Sweet.
And I will put his token on the map. So you'll be in charge of that.
Okay.
I wonder if I can't assign that to you, I don't think.
No, the way that I did it in previous games was I just created another, I let that player create another PC and then just filled in the stats for the Raven. That way it was controlled by them.
Okay, so
But
that'll
I
take
can
some t
track it.
yeah, that'll take some time to do, but so that's what we will do eventually, but for now we'll just do it the way we have it so we can press on here. Okay, cool. So you got your Raven.
Thanks.
Name him Nevermore.
Right, because of that.
There's
Okay,
no
so
limit of how far we can move with this, is there?
no, but
Hold me.
I'm going to, yeah, don't go any further than that because I am going to lock tokens as soon as I figure out how to do it.
Ah, okay.
How do I manipulate the yellow arrow where I look?
Zook
You should
is like
scroll where Lemon.
walking backward through the brush.
Yeah,
You
I don't know
cover
how
it in our
I can.
back. Hover your mouse over the little token and use your mouse wheel. I'm assuming you've got a mouse wheel.
Once he locks him, you can't do that anymore.
Ah, okay.
Right, I locked the token, so you guys can now when you try to move your token, it will draw a path and I'll have to approve it. And it won't let you guys face your tokens either.
No.
Nope.
Okay, so
Ah,
I'll take care of
thanks.
that. Okay, so oh, look what I put there. The corpse of a human male is sprawled here on its back. It wears only leather breeches.
I'll check it out with a survival to see what killed it.
Where is it?
Wait, can I do that?
Oh, sorry. It's a little bit inside the cave, so let me open that up.
Oh, okay.
I need to draw this. Okay, so that's where you see, and then it's basically just lying right in the middle there, just on the ground. So you guys can move up to that if you want.
All right, so I want to basically be in stealth like all the time. So, just let me know when you want me to do stealth checks or whatever.
Okay, well, we did one to get up here, and everybody crapped out. So everybody's moving up there. I'm assuming you're sending the Raven over to just kind of check it out.
Yep, I do.
Okay, so dead body, as I said, dead body, as I said. Sorry, sometimes I realize I haven't been pushing my push to talk, and I say stuff, and I'm like, why isn't anybody talking back to me?
Can you mark the dead body with an X or something?
It's right where the Raven is.
Ah, okay, then.
He's pecking its eyes out like Diablo 1.
There, I put an X. Okay, so it's a dead body. What do you guys want to do?
Can I do a
Loot it.
survival check to see if, well, to see if I can find out what killed it?
Do a what check?
Survival check.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
It's more like medicine, or?
well, it's whatever check I ask for. So usually the
Oh.
best way for if you want to roll stuff, I know everyone's excited to roll dice all the time because so am I. But don't, yeah, any check that I ask for would be something I ask for. Usually it's not a way to do it where you say. In very rare circumstances will I agree to, hey, can I do this or can I do that? I'll just ask you to make a check. You just tell me what you want to do. And
Oh,
then
okay, then I'd
but don't
like
tell me
find out
what
what
don't
killed
tell
it.
me what ability you want to use. But you guys are, you know, keep don't be afraid to tell me. Like if I say, hey, make a Arcana check, you don't be afraid to say, wouldn't that be more history or what? You know, you can ask me. But
Okay.
you know, so don't be afraid
Okay.
of, you know, I'm not going to shut you guys down or tell you know, fuck off or none of that stuff. But usually, just you don't really ask to make checks unless I ask for it. Just tell me what you guys want to do is all.
Okay, I want to look the body if there are like tracks around it, if how he got killed, if there are like wounds or something.
It's just a typical looking dead body.
It's a corpse, or isn't it like, is there flesh still on it?
A human male sprawled here on its back. It wears leather breeches. Okay. Yeah, there's nothing, I mean, there's no more information about it that I have that you guys don't have, but it's just laying there dead. So you know, you can pretty much know by that a dead body's not good.
Does it have like blade marks or teeth marks or?
Okay. In this case, roll a perception check, and everyone who's looking at the body can do that.
I'm gonna be keeping my eye out to the north.
Okay.
Let them deal with the body.
There we go. 23. That's good. You don't see anything unusual. He's lying on his back, but you don't see any particular cause of death. He's just dead.
Does he have anything on him? Like, I'm looking for... Does he have any money?
By the way, you guys need to try to do your best to stay within the confines of a particular square. So, like, right now, there's people on top of each other and stuff like that. So, like... That's more what I'm looking for as far as, like, keeping in your own square and, you know what I mean, stuff like that.
All right.
And I might even just turn this facing bullshit off because it's making me crazy now.
Yeah, tons of yellow arrows.
I kind of gave up on it.
Yeah, I'm just going to... Because if you guys can't control it, I didn't know that. I thought you guys could control your facing. So let me find that in here. And blah, blah, blah. Enemy health, enemy show name. Facing, there it is. Off, bam. Oh! I just knocked everybody on their ass. So now when you put your token, your mouse thing over
it's
your token,
it's locked at the moment because we can't do our own movement.
Oh, right.
There we go.
If that isn't the most fucking precise bullshit, you have to... God damn it.
Help me.
it's like the thing in your bath, you know, an eighth of an inch is 1,000 degrees in your shower. All right. Hey, by the way, next time we play, all this fucking bullshit won't take as long, hopefully. Okay. So somebody said they wanted to know if he had any money.
Yeah.
Are you going to search his body?
If that's what I need to do, that's what I'll do.
Don't touch it. Oh, so the second he touches it, guess what?
Uh-oh. Comes to life.
Good job. Let's just walk around random caves touching dead bodies.
Everybody, roll initiative. That's what you've been waiting for 2 hours for me to say, isn't it?
Exactly.
I can't see the creep in his eyes.
Does everybody know how to roll? Oh, by the way, on your character sheet on the front page is initiative. I found, for those of you that don't know this already, if you drag that down to your hot bar and put it in like the first position on your hot bar... From now on, all you'll have to do is click that, and it'll be easy.
Oh, great. I wonder what those numbers were.
Who rolled twice? What happened?
I don't think anybody did.
Oh, no, perception, I see. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, oh my god, look at that, 23, that's awesome. Okay, so initiative, 4 people, great. Hi, I'm a friendly zombie. That's his voice. He's very effeminate. Hi. So it is. My mouse's turn to act funny. Lyodin, it is your turn. What would you like to do?
Drawing both swords, moving over half my movement, and trying to kill the zombie again.
Okay. Go for it. So you're that movement puts you on a line. Try to end up with the thing in the middle of a square. Okay, and I see that you've targeted him, so fire away on your attack, sir. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do, you guys. I see that he knows what he's doing, and he's kind of done it all. But how we're gonna do this is, if you have two attacks, we're gonna do one attack, and then if you hit, I'll say roll damage, and then you do that. If you have two attacks like he did, we're gonna do hit, damage, and then attack, and we're gonna do it that way. But we'll take what you have there. That's fine. So what you did, two attacks and hit once for 5 damage, right on. And so that's a movement and an action. Anything else?
No.
Okay. Combat has begun, ladies and gentlemen. Well, there's no ladies. Maybe the zombie's a lady. No, he's not a lady. He's just effeminate. Okay, so Zook, what would you like to do?
I cast Chill Touch, my cantrip.
Okay. Make sure that you have the zombie targeted. Okay. So you didn't have him targeted, but that's okay. Since you didn't have him targeted, we can go through how to do that. Go ahead and grab your attack that you just made, the 18, and drag it into the combat tracker on top of the zombie.
I think you can drag it onto the token as well.
You can
right?
also drag it on the token. Yeah, there's two ways you can do it. Have you done it?
One second.
Okay, no problem. Take your time. Because then it'll tell us, you know, hit or miss or whatever. Oh, and by the way, while he's looking into doing that, for those of you that don't know, how to target somebody is you hold down control and click on either the token or the thing in the combat tracker, and it will target it, and it'll say under your character, target zombie. Okay, so you hit, so go ahead and roll damage.
Whoa.
Awesome, good job.
Just roll min. Awesome. Okay, to pass your turn at the bottom left of the combat tracker, just hit next actor. Or in turn, I think it says for you guys.
Yeah, I have only round.
On the bottom left of that window, there should be a little dragon head with a down arrow that says end turn. Yeah, there you go. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Raven's turn.
Who's got the raven?
Me, Zook.
Okay, so that should actually be a 15. Did you roll? Oh no, I'm sorry, that's a 13. You rolled his initiative?
Nope.
Oh, I guess the system must have done it. Okay, so the raven goes now, but it can't attack or anything, but what do you want it to do?
I let him fly behind me.
Okie doke. And then, do you have the ability?
Ready in action.
And what readied action would you like?
I mean, if I need to do some kind of saving throw, he can help me so that I get advantage, or...
Okay, you don't need to really ready an action for that. It'll just... That's just nothing. That's a condition of it all the time, right?
Okay, so nothing.
Okay, so you don't have the ability to pass the turn for him, do you?
Nope.
Okay, so Kroll, what would you like to do?
Come on, Kroll.
I'm going to hit him in my axe. Oh, don't worry. I got this.
He's got it.
Oh.
Hit.
Yeah. Okay.
Zombies suck. Yeah, okay. Roll your damage.
Crunch.
Yay. Oh, he's Flat. Critical.
Nice.
He's not liking it. He's not liking it. Anything else?
Nope, that's what I've got.
Bosco.
Come on, balls.
All right, man. I'm going to use my shillelagh. Is that right?
I'm going to smash in the face with my shillelagh. Yeah, that's fine.
Shillelagh.
Roll your attack on that. Make sure you have them targeted.
So I hold control, right?
Hold control and then click on the token or the thing in the...
Oh, God. No. Okay, how do I drag it over there?
Grab what you just threw in the in the window. And no, there's no re-rolls. You're taking the 11.
Oh, well, dang it.
End your turn.
You hit anyway. So, no, nice. Yeah, 11 hits because zombies suck ass. So okay. roll your damage.
That's why they smell.
Oh, everybody got a chance to have a turn, and that zombie is dead.
You said they suck ass, but he took quite a few hits from all of us.
He did. I'm talking about, when I say suck ass, I was referring to armor class only.
Right, okay.
Okay, hold on a second. Wait, what did I do? I might have screwed that up. Hold on, everybody just calm down.
We're calm.
Yeah, you're calm. That's one of my little... Yeah, I'm the one who needs to calm the fuck down. He had, okay, he needs to make a save here. Hold on.
Oh, he might not be dead.
I need him. Yeah, he might not be dead. I need to get him
back.
Cut
his damn head off. Smash his head. Cruel.
Gets back
off. Aim for the head, idiot.
God, zombie killer noob. Come on.
Right.
He got raised again.
Okay, let's see. Hold on. I don't understand. 0 to 5. Okay. Constitution saving throw.
Thanks, Boonhauer.
That was a great show.
Why doesn't it let me? Oh, there we go. Oh, you guys weren't supposed to see that. Okay, you did 6 plus 5 is 11. He did not make his saving throw, so he does not pop back up.
Yay.
So he is, in fact, dead.
Does he have any gold on him?
Son of a bitch. He does not. He's just a dead dude. I think that was, that's literally the first thing you guys were supposed to encounter, so it was a little wet-your-whistle combat thing there, so that's good, though, because I get to put that in the experience place.
Hey, Zook, do you have a light spell?
What?
Do you have a light spell?
I do.
Is it a cantrip?
No, I don't.
Yes.
Good. Because yeah. I'm human and I can't see in the dark, so I'm assuming going into this cave, shit's gonna get real.
I can give you a torch.
Yeah, what? But I can't carry it. I'm using two weapons.
Ah, right. Okay.
Yeah, I'll just keep my produce flame up. It's just a cantrip. It gives us 10 feet good vision and another 10 feet dim vision.
Okay, so at this point, somebody has...
Or you can cast.
Oh, go ahead, I'm sorry. You guys are talking about, putting on some light and doing stuff like
or
that.
Or you could cast light on the raven, I believe.
That's not a good idea.
Using it as a portable torch.
No, that's not good. It makes him an easy target.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I'd rather him be a target than us, but...
Yeah, I'm okay with risking the raven.
I'm not.
You can always summon it's another free. One. Just go buy some incense. Do what you do.
No, I'm one of these DMs. I'm not so much into the spell components and whatever. That just gets too bogged down and it's too crazy. But he does have to cast a spell, and it does take an hour to do it. And he's only got 2 spell slots, so it's expensive for him to get this. Okay, so you guys are in the we can deal with...
I mean, I can see 120 feet. It's for me daylight.
Moving on.
Yeah, which I'm trying to do here. Hold on. Okay, so, you guys are able to see, somebody's brave enough, they want to go already.
Looking for zombies.
Being cruel, we got it, buddy.
Why is your health bar above your head? That's crazy. Okay, so let me fix this map.
Now that the zombie is dead, I want to check him out if he has something to loot.
We already did that. Nothing.
Oh, okay.
He's got a pair of leather breeches.
Greedy ass tried to look at his gold and he didn't have anything.
Look at his what?
Gold, which he has none of.
Oh.
We could take the pants. They must be worth something. Actually, can I do that?
Oh, this thing's got to smell horrible. You're carrying them.
Alright, I've got a rucksack.
Yeah, put it right next to the tent.
And my rations. Charisma drops by one. Permanently.
Is there anything fishy about this cave entrance at all, or is this, I mean, does it look man-made?
No, it doesn't look man-made. It's pretty natural. Didn't the description of the cave already get sent to you guys? See, and that's another thing you'll find with me, and I apologize, and I'll probably keep apologizing for it, unless I could just do a blanket apology. My memory is shit. So, like, literally 2 minutes after I tell you something, I'll forget it. Which, by the way, I'll trust you guys not to take advantage of that. But I could have swore, yeah, the cave mouth opens. There you go, right there. Thank you, David.
I actually did it first, but
thank you, everybody. Thank you for both you guys.
You said that because you couldn't remember my name, didn't you?
No, I just didn't. I told you guys I don't look in the chat window, but I was gonna go put that in there, and then I just looked and saw it there.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, I'm learning. I know everybody's name.
We're inside the cave now, right?
You guys are inside the cave. I know that you have moves pending, but I'm looking to see. I don't want to move you yet, because I don't know if you know, you might be walking into a trap. You might be, who knows what's in there.
Okay. Well, as we're moving, I'm going to be as stealthy as always.
Okay, I'll
There's
ask
nothing
you.
To the north of us, is that?
Me too.
If you guys want to make new stealth rolls at this point, you can attempt that.
I'm happy not stealthing.
Yeah, I'll take that.
Ah, Christ. I mean, I'm not, oh my God, look at you guys, this is awesome.
God dang.
But, is there any cave coming from the north of us, or is it just this one passage?
Son of a bitch, I just opened up the letter, it's V for you guys, didn't mean to do that. I'm trying to show you what's there.
Okay.
Okay, so,
So there are no little side paths. It's just a straight walk.
What you guys can see is there's no paths off, at least as far as you can see up there.
Okay.
And keep in mind that you guys will always be a little ahead of me. As players, it's really easy for you guys to go, okay, what's up there, what's up there? But as a DM, I gotta kind of get that shit set up. So just, bear with me if you can, guys.
Oh, sorry, okay. I didn't want to sound like I was trying to rush you.
So, let's see.
Just for the rest of the party, maybe keep a little bit of distance between me and Cruel and you guys, just in case we happen to set off a trap or something, you guys don't get caught in it.
Don't tell them that.
Or, you know, take a volley of crossbow bolts from somewhere up ahead or something.
Oh wait, that's an option. Oops.
That Does someone has a torch now lit up, or we don't?
I think the only light we've got is Bull's magic.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, I mean, do y'all want me to turn it on?
I thought it already was on.
Okay, well then yes it is.
Not sure how you're stealthing though, with a big light around you.
Okay, who made, somebody with stealth. Liadin and Zook both got awesome stealth rolls, so you guys are all in quiet mode. Everybody else is not. So, this is, we're not in combat or anything, but this is the part where, as you guys explore further up, and let me draw what you can see here. This damn thing. Okay, so that should be that. That's about what you guys can see now. A round high ceiling cave opens here. It has two narrow exits, one leading to the north and to the south. A flat boulder sits in the center of the cave. It's about 6 feet across, 8 feet long, and 3 feet high. Dark stains color its top. You guys aren't quite up there far enough to see it yet, but as you approach, just tell me how you guys want to go up there. Two people are stealth, so you can assumedly, like, go up there all quiet-like.
So, to find traps...
if you're searching... Like... Yeah, if you're searching for traps, we would just do that. If you have thieves' tools and or are proficient in it, we would handle that. If none of you do, then we would just do perception rolls to search for traps, if that's what you want to do. So that's a good example. When I say, you know, because I won't say, do you guys want to search for traps? I'll say, what do you guys want to do? And if you say search for traps, then we'll do that. But at this point, just tell me, you know, generally speaking, at this point, you guys are back. You just killed a zombie, which was awesome. And so now you see up into this cave area. So what do you guys want to do?
Yeah, I'd like to start searching for traps as we go.
Okay, so make a perception roll for that.
Yeah, that's not going to end well.
That's pretty good. Okay, so at this point, you do not sense any traps at all.
All right, continuing on.
Yeah, no, we're pretty confident. Pretty happily ahead then.
Okay, so let's see. Let me move everybody. 30, 20, 25, 10. The bird. Okay. Okay. So you still don't see anything in the room except for that stone. Who's up front there? Is that a stealthy person?
Yeah, that's Leiden.
Okay. Cool. Oh yeah, because you can read the names of the characters if you scroll in, and it's microscopic. This goddamn map. Okay. So. Since you're closest, Liadin, what do you want to do at this point? Do you want to go further? Do you want to... I mean, there's no traps.
Can I see the ceiling?
Yeah, you can see the ceiling. It's pretty high. It's probably like 30 feet.
I'd like to look at the ceiling above that rock.
Okay. It's not any... There's not anything special about the ceiling. But... like, are you looking for anything in particular?
Just looking, like, was there, like a hole in the ceiling? Was something being, like, poured down onto the rock? Does it look like blood? You know, something like along those lines.
At this distance, you're not too sure, but you roll an investigation check. Yeah, so I think from here you can probably tell that it is blood. It's dry blood.
Can I listen if there are some kind of noises?
It's pretty silent. You don't even need to roll anything. It's pretty silent. You guys don't really hear anything.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and move up.
Okay. Wow, that health bar is just flying off the top of your head there. That's awesome. I don't understand why. That's funny. Okay, so at this point, as soon as he moves up there, Kroll is going to experience rocks coming down on his head from the two zombies that are standing up on ledges out of sight. And they knock a bunch of rocks down.
But outsmarted by zombies.
Well, I mean, is it half work? I mean, come on.
Okay, so let's see. They've got a wooden box full of rocks.
And pretty smart zombies.
Yeah.
They let the box go, and so you need to succeed on a dexterity saving throw. So go ahead and make that. Do that in the dice tower, please. It's fine. It's fine. You can leave it in there. Yeah, I didn't say that in time. That's fine. So you needed a 12. You got a 14. That's awesome.
Yay.
And so you managed to jump out of the way of these rocks that they dump on you. And
are the rocks covering the passageway?
Oh, they're there, but it doesn't make any difficult terrain or anything. They just dumped a bunch of rocks. Okay. You know, they tried to dump it on your head, but you jumped out of the way because you're awesome dexterity roll. So at this point, everyone, please roll initiative. I know that's your favorite thing to hear me say, you guys.
This now, rolled 18.
Damn! Oh, okay, so, whoops, that thing went away. Crap. Okay, so, these zombies, are up on a ledge. So, it is now, they're 10 feet above you. So, Bosco, what do you want to do?
Okay, so like where I'm at, if I move this 30 feet and I'm essentially next to them, can I see them even though they're 10 feet above me? Or would I need to go further so that I can actually see them on the ledge?
Oh, right, I need to move your guy. Okay, so...
I was going here, but then combat started, so I would actually need to go further.
So you... right, but you now have your full movement.
Okay.
I'm going to say that, no, actually, I have to take that back. You moved 25. What is your movement?
It's 30. So I can still move 5 feet.
Yes, you can. Yes.
But if I move here, can I see them? From here, at this angle?
Yes, you can see them. They're above you on a ledge, but yes, you can see them.
Okay. Well then I'm gonna attack the one, closest to me. I'm gonna, what is that, zombie number what?
11.
Okay. I'm going to...
What are you gonna attack him with?
Produce flame.
Okay. Make sure you target him first. Hit! Roll your damage.
That was kind of cool. When you said hit, it had like an echo to it, like you're a gladiator announcer or something.
Nice, Sue.
It was a hit. Okay, I'm not going to do
Das Raider.
Okay,
is it safe
so
to assume you can't hit them with melee?
Well, they're 10 feet up above you, so if you can explain to me how you're going to do that, yes, but I doubt you can.
Right, okay.
So he took his damage, and Bosco, anything else?
Kroll hasn't got hit yet, so that, yeah, that's my action, and I don't have a bonus that I want to use.
Okay, pass the turn.
Oh, my bad. I was last, so...
Okay,
I can walk only...
Zook.
I'm gonna walk here.
Okie doke.
Do I see anything from there?
You can see... both zombies, but if you were to do anything with them, the one on the left would have cover. The one on the right, I believe, there's no... you could get... Or the one on the left would have superior cover, the one on the right would have cover.
Then I want to use my cantrip on the one of the right.
Okay. Which cantrip?
The same as before.
Okay, no problem. If you make sure you have them targeted and go for it.
I do target with...
Control? Yeah, control, and there you go.
Ah, cool.
Yeah, hit.
Can I roll damage?
Absolutely. Okay, he takes his damage. And anything else?
The effect from the spell will be automatically, or...
What is that? What did you chill touch? What effect does it give him?
It gives under disadvantage on the next attack.
Okay, so hold on a second. Let me find chill touch on your sheet here.
Yep.
It gives disadvantage to him attacking you or to attacking anybody.
Can I put the description in the chat somehow?
Oh, I see it. I just was hoping you knew, but I can read it. Because your effect, it's on your actions tab. The effect is there. All you have to do is click the effect. But
it says
grant advantage for attack self. Or, I mean,
okay.
So that would only mean he would get disadvantage if he attacked you.
Okay.
Is that how you understand the spell to work?
Yes.
Okay.
I understand it the same way.
So then, yeah, so then just click, in your, do you see where it says effect, target, grant advantage, self? Or grant,
yes,
yeah,
I clicked this.
Yeah.
But I got an error, unable to decode effect details.
How interesting. That is bad. Why did that happen? Anybody know why that happened? Let's see. Unable to decode defect detail. Oh, it's probably in there wrong. Let's see. Yes, that is, that's in there wrong. Let's see if we can fix that.
Should I click it, or can you click it?
Well, I needed to see, like, the other one says, note, can't regain hit points. That will also not work. It has to be in a very specific... Did you put those in there like that?
No, I tracked just the spelling from the book.
Okay, so, yeah, sometimes it doesn't parse correctly, but, there you go.
Cool.
So you, I changed it to so that it shows the what it is and how long it is, and it's all automatic for you now. Okay, right
on.
That's nice. So see, the nice thing is we won't have to do that again. We just do it once, and then now it'll work.
Thank you. That's all I do.
Okay, pass your turn, and Kroll, it is your turn. What would you like? Oh, he's got his move in there.
Okay, so I'm assuming my character is about 6'2".
Okay.
Am I able to grab onto the zombie's ankle and pull him down?
You would have to make an athletics check to be successful at that. So if you want to give that a try.
Okay. I think I'm pretty good at that.
Yeah, I'm going to say you're not able to grab him.
Nah. All right.
At this time.
I guess I'm not able to do another action, am I?
Right. But you could move, but your action is spent.
Is climbing counted as moving?
Yes, you can climb at, I believe, half your speed. But he's up there. There's really no room. Like, if you climbed up there, you'd be squeezing. I mean, there's no room up there.
In that case, I don't think I've got much I can do. I'll end my turn.
Okay. Before I approve, well, no, they're 10 feet up. That's not going to draw an opportunity attack. You can move there.
All right. Now, as soon as I get there, I'm dropping my two swords and drawing my crossbow.
Okay, that's free action.
And I'm going to fire at that guy.
At the zombie number 3? Okay. What crit? Whatever.
Wow.
Critical hit, knockdown. In addition to the standard critical hit, you knock the target prone. Oh, nice. That bitch ass is down.
Does he fall off the ledge, or?
No, he falls down on the ledge. Let me, because although that's awesome, he's going to now be, for people who attack him ranged, you'll be at a disadvantage. But let me knock his ass prone.
Yeah, my crossbow bolt hit him so hard it knocked him off his feet.
Bam. Crit.
And how much movement would I have to take? Because I still have 5 feet left. I don't know how much it takes or how that works in fifth to basically, like, drop my crossbow now and then bend down and pick up my swords.
Oh, you can't do that this turn, but every turn you have a free interaction to, how does it go? Every turn you get a free interaction to interact with one item. So dropping both your swords, and then dropping something doesn't really count, but grabbing your crossbow or whatever you had, that was okay. So next time you can pick up both your swords, but you'd have to drop your crossbow. If you sheathe your crossbow, you can't pick up your swords. You know what I mean?
Could I use my bonus action?
Well, bonus actions are bonus actions and actions are actions. So you can't use a bonus action to interact with a weapon. The way I understand it is, That is a free thing, but you can't interact with two different items, only one. I'm counting the swords as one thing, but in other words, you can't interact with the swords and the crossbow in the same turn. You know what I mean?
Gotcha.
Okay. So you're done at this point, yeah? Nice job. Okay, Zombie 11. Ho, ho, ho. He ain't happy. Try to grab his ankle grabber.
It didn't have much of a choice.
He was going to bite his ankles.
He jumps down, but in doing so, takes...
He about to kill himself.
Damage. He takes fall damage. He's not happy. he's looking at the ankle biter. He wants you.
Hey, I want him too.
And he is going to make a slam attack against you. And miss, because he's a stupid zombie.
That was really anticlimactic.
Okay, so zombie number 3 is going to stand up. So he is no longer prone. And he will also jump down. He, for doing so, will also take fall damage, because he's stupid.
And break his hip.
They're zombies. That doesn't really do much to him.
And he has moved. He has taken his damage. And he will now attack. And he will hit. And does 4 damage to Mr. Lyodin, but he is finished. The Raven. What's the Raven doing?
Skip him.
Back in the cave. Punk-ass Raven.
He's on watch out duty.
Okay, he's looking out there. Okay.
Yeah.
So, new round. Bosco.
Wow, this kind of sucks, because, like, I can't run past them, right?
You can't run past them, per se, because you can run up to them, but, I see, you're right there. Yeah, well, so what do you want to do? If you just tell me what you want to do, and I'll tell you what would happen. I'm not going to commit you to it.
If I wanted to, like, get all the way over here, further back...
Well, when you say over here, I don't really...
Oh, okay.
If you want to go there? Okay, so yeah, if you go there, you will take an opportunity attack from the zombie.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
If you want to cancel your move, just pick your token up and put it back where it is, and it'll cancel the move.
Can you do that in 5th, where you can make some sort of, like, tumble or acrobatics check to not incur an attack?
Well, yeah, you can do what's called disengage, so he can go there and not take an opportunity attack, but then he would not have his action.
Would I have a... Okay. What if I go here?
Then you don't take an attack. You can go there for free.
Okay.
Do you want to do that?
Yeah. I'll move there. Okay. And then I'm going to hit 11 with my shillelagh.
Okay. Hit.
Did he just attack Cruel?
Yes, he did.
Uh-oh.
What? Oh my god, Cruel, I'm a terrible person.
I'll fix it.
My combat track, oh my god.
Can I hit him back?
I'll fix it.
Traitor!
He just got hit in the back by a wooden club.
Your attack would have hit the zombie anyway, so I will give the zombie that damage.
My bad, I'm sorry.
Oh, you hit me for a 9.
Shows up late, hits his own party members.
And in reality, what happened was you killed the zombie.
Hooray!
Hooray!
Yeah!
Does this one have a chance to come back to life, or was it just...
Yes, it does, but he has to make a fantastic roll for that to happen. Hold on.
I tried dropping the dice on the map as opposed to the... combat
tracker,
and I hadn't zoomed in enough.
Yeah,
so that was
you can do that. It's player's preference, but me as a player and as a DM, I prefer that you target the person in the combat tracker, see that it says that you've targeted them, so that you can read it, target zombie 3, and you're not targeting your friend, and then make your attack roll, rather than dropping it and dragging it, because that's what happens is all those things get all screwed up sometimes. Okay, so let me make this guy save here. Oh, bam! He's back up. But he only has 1 hit point. So let's see. And he was there. Okay, so he's back up, but he only has, he's just barely alive. So, Zook?
I will attack the one that just came back up.
Okay. Yeah, he's dead. Boom. Aww.
Plastered away.
He can't do that. He can't come back twice, so good times.
So to end my turn.
Okay, Crawl.
Yep, gonna move there and then hit with my axe.
Hit him.
Or move, sorry.
With your axe. Go for it. Mm-hmm. If a 24 don't hit, I don't know what does. 5 damage, and he is not looking good. So move.
He's not dead yet.
Attack, not dead. Anything else?
I don't think I can do anything else.
Unless you have a bonus action. You can also move. In 5th edition, you can move a portion of your move. You can split your move up any way you want. You can move 5 feet, make an attack, move another 5. You know, you can do that. But in your case, if you move away from him out of his range, you'll take an attack. So I wouldn't really want to move.
What if I was to move within range of him, so I just went to the tower below him?
That's the thing about 5th edition. You can kind of dance all around him all you want, as long as you don't leave his...
Right,
his,
okay.
Yeah, you can do that. Did you want to move again?
I've already ended my turn. Okay. Do I have to move out of the way for Bulls to be able to hit him? I'm not sure if there's, like, line of sight or not.
And if you're completely blocking somebody, that there might be cover, but otherwise it's fine.
Okay.
Leiden.
Alright, I'm gonna drop my crossbow and pick up my swords.
Okie doke.
And then attack Mr. Zombie.
Mr. Zombie is waiting for your attack. He doesn't like it. He sincerely doesn't like it. Okay, he's gotta make his save now. See if he comes back. What the hell? This damn thing.
What happened?
By virtue of the keys and hotkeys that you have to press and to move to the map and get to the dice tower and everything, I just opened a little teeny section of the map. You guys, it doesn't even show anything, but it's not what I meant to do. Okay, now let me do his save, if I can even find the guy now. Yeah, I see why people, I've seen people, you know, like on Twitch or YouTube or whatever, playing this game, and they say, oh, my fourth screen, I can see now why you'd need multiple screens.
Too many windows.
Exactly. Okay, he in no way makes that save, so he's dead. So, good job, you dispatched of the 2 zombies. And that is all that was here at this point, so let me put that experience in the party tracker, so I don't forget. Good times.
Now, Leiden, you are a little hurt. Do you want me to full heal you up?
Or I'm okay. Unless you have a cantrip that can do it. Otherwise, I'm okay for now.
There are no cantrip pills.
Well, then I guess I'm okay. If it comes down to it, I can always use Second Wind, which will give me a little bit back.
Okay. No worries.
Okay, guys, so at this point, I can open up the map a little bit more so you can see down those hallways there. However, I have been remiss. We were, from official start time, we're almost 3 hours in, and I have not taken a break, and I myself need to pee. So why don't we take 5 or 10? Do you guys want to take a 5-minute break, 10-minute break? What do you guys want to do?
I'm happy either way.
Okay, so unless anybody wants to go longer, we'll say it's 5, and then 5 minutes. Yeah, I can't vote. I'm a DM. Yeah, so it looks like 5 minutes. All right, cool. So we'll come back by the top of the hour here.
Cool. Like how you were stood basically out of the fight the entire time then.
Is someone still here?
I'm back.
And Sasas?
We'll do a vote ready. They probably still are gone.
Okay.
So, Rob, is there any gold on these zombies?
Zombies never have gold.
Well, it's my character. I have, like, my flaw is that I have to always look for gold and coins on the ground to take. So.
Okay, that's cool. But so that you don't have to ask me and I don't have to say it all the time. there's not going to be... I mean, I'll make it pretty obvious. I'll say, do you guys want to check the bodies? But zombies never have gold. They never have anything.
Right.
They have rotten flesh. Oh, I forgot my raven.
I moved the raven up just because I'm gonna change the map, and I didn't want to have to go approve that move, so I just moved him up a little because he's not in danger at this point.
Yes, thank you. I will just use it anyway. I just forgot it because I had it too far zoomed in, so I didn't see him anymore.
Okay, just waiting on one person and we'll get back to her.
So what's like the maximum number of people you can have in one game?
Well, we're doing Adventurers League, which is you have to have between 3 and 7.
Right.
But in a normal game, there is no minimum or maximum. You can have a DM and one player, or you could have 10 players. The thing about having a lot of players, though, is imagine waiting like half an hour or 45 minutes between each turn you take. I mean, it would be ridiculous.
I was wondering if maybe you could have multiple GMs, though. In the same game, and then they will take care of like 5 people.
Yeah, people do that. People switch around, like you know, I'll DM for a month and you DM for a month, and I know people that do that in their home games. Just
I mean, like 2 GMs at the same time taking care of 2 groups, but you're on the same map.
Yeah, I've done that actually. What you're talking about there, but that's only when. When I've done the 2DM thing, it's easier to split groups. So if this group wants to go in town, but the other group wants to go to the farmhouse or something, that helps. But usually, if you do the 2DMs, one is going to control like the NPC portion, and the other one would do like combat. Because if they try to both do combat, it actually makes things worse.
Yeah, and if you have 2 different parties on the same map. It wouldn't really work because, you know, I think what you're saying is it would really be one big party, but it would be 2 groups of 5 or whatever, but they'd all be going to the same location. But that would just, I mean, I suppose that's possible, but in my head, I'm thinking what a nightmare that would be. I would never want to be any part of that.
And you got to also think about how long it takes to get back to your turn. So right. You have 10 people at the table. Well,
if you've got two GMs, though, you'd do, like, two
if it's one big group of 10 people and you have two groups of five acting independently, one group is going to do something to fuck something up for the other group without them even knowing about it, and it'd just be crazy. I mean, I like I said, it's possible, but I wouldn't want anything to do with it as a player or a GM.
I don't know, I just thought it'd be kind of cool to do, like, a larger scale thing at some point.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure at conventions and stuff, they probably do kind of stuff like that. I'm sure they do.
All right.
Okay, who's not back? What's going on? That's 10 minutes. We voted for 5. Is it Raz? Kick him out. Okay, well, we'll just press on. Whoever's missing can catch up. So, what do you guys think? There's two ways to go down the passageways. What do you guys want to do?
Is there any point in checking out the rock?
Oh, checking out the rock.
Yeah.
Now
that we can get personally.
Yeah, there's really no more information about it, just that there's dried blood on it. But there's no extra information about it. There's nothing else about it that you would need to know.
Ah, okay.
But good call. Well, always be checking stuff.
Is that like a clue that I should be checking something else?
No, not at all. I'm just saying don't feel that you're wasting your time, but in this case there is absolutely nothing else to learn.
So in this case it is actually just wasting my time.
Yeah, in this case, right. But that's why I was making the point. Never be afraid to, you know, ask about like what the hell's going on.
I say we send the Raven to scout these passageways.
Okay.
But what if we send the Raven to scout one way and then the rest of us went the other?
I send him here.
At least a little bit of both.
Okay, yeah, so you can send him there.
I mean, I play Wizards too, and let's be honest, he's a familiar. He's pretty expendable. He's not like a PC.
Right.
I understand that, you know, it might take an hour to summon another one, but it's not like second edition where if you lose your familiar, you lose, like, a whole level of hit points or anything like that. I mean, it's just an hour of time, really.
Yeah.
And the components, but we don't lose the components, okay.
Yeah, I'm not... The components are so, like, who cares, you know?
Well, I guess we're safe enough to be able to take an hour break and resummon him anyway, right?
Oh, if you want.
Okay, maybe safe enough.
Okay, so do you guys want to... is everybody back? I'm still missing a check mark in there.
I think Krul is not here.
Okay.
No, I'm here.
Oh, there we go. Oh. I got it. I got everybody. Okay, so...
One question. All right.
Somebody wants to move up.
Can't see in the dark.
I'll bite.
So the Raven can't see in the dark, right?
Yes, that's what I was asking.
Yeah, so it... I don't know. Can it?
So we set fire to the Raven first.
No. I don't know. It doesn't say anything.
Okay, then... unless
you have to look in the monster's manual.
Unless it specifically says it can, I'm going to say it can't. That I know of, birds can't see in the dark. Okay, so...
Can you cast the light thing on it?
You guys can cast light on it if you want. My warning to you as a DM, I think somebody even said it before. Somebody didn't end their movement in a square there, that's fine. Somebody said it before, I think, which is not a good idea to have a shining light go flying off down hallways and stuff. Unless you guys specifically want to do that for a certain reason.
What we can do is we put a torch here, and I have the Raven to watch our back if something comes from the other tunnel.
Yeah, you can certainly do that.
Could we split up?
No, that is not advised. There's an actual saying in D&D.
Never split the party.
Never split the party. That is a hugely bad idea.
Yeah, we all go the same way. The Raven just watches the other tunnel so we don't get zombies falling in our back.
Alright, we can, we'll take the right path, but I just want to look at the north and see what I see.
Yeah, there's two lines that indicate that there might be something weird about that right there, but that's nothing. There's, up top there on the north side, there it's just marks. There's nothing, there's no passageway or anything there at all.
I thought you said there was a narrow passage to the north.
Did I?
The north is to the right on this
No,
map.
no.
If you look
Area.
at the
Is it? Oh, is it?
if you look at the compass at the bottom left, it's pointing to the right.
Oh god, I hate that so much.
Oh god,
north
I hate
should be
that.
up.
I hate it. I hate it. You're right, but in this case, it is actually to the right. Oh my god, it's gonna fuck me up. Okay,
Is there a way to maybe flip the map?
Can you even do that?
I know there's some buttons at the top. Oh,
yeah,
they don't.
None
I
of
don't
those.
Think
none of
it
those are.
But...
I don't think you can flip the map. Actually, I would have seen that sometime. No, I don't see on any of these commands. I can't flip it. Okay, so let me get back to where we were here. Okay, so let me get you guys moved in where you want to go. Lyodin's path is a 35-foot movement in a straight line, but you can't make that straight line move. We're not in combat at this point, so it doesn't really matter. But just to let you guys know, when you draw your character on a long movement like that, actually draw the path, so you would draw it around the rocks, and how you do that is you make a move, you hold control, and then move, and then let go, and move, and you guys will see how to do it, but you... you know, so that you can draw your path, because that later on might come into play, like if you're passing things, or yeah, like here's some crazy movement there, yeah, like that. Okay, so somebody wants to move in though, so we'll get you guys all in there, whatever. And I'll open this up.
Yeah, I didn't quite get that with the whole, because I'm holding control and it's not like doing a path for me or anything.
So like
are you
letting
go
this?
Of the
you hold
and then
you hold okay, you hold control, you move, you make your move, you let go of the mouse, and then you re-grab the end of your movement and move it again. There you go. Okay, so let me open this up for you guys. I have to click a different button to I'll get you guys all in there.
Ah, there's definitely gonna be a boss in here, isn't there?
Look at that move. Check that out. Yeah, he's crazy. Okay, so
I'd like to check each side before I go in.
At
Can
this
I
point,
do that?
What do you mean by check each side?
Well, I mean there were zombies waiting to ambush me last time, and I'm thinking maybe look each side. Make sure there isn't.
Oh, yeah. There's no ledges in this case. As a matter of fact, here's what
okay.
we got. Here's what we got going. Motionless humanoid figures dressed in dirty clothes or scraps of armor are propped against the walls in this cave. Some are little more than skeletons with wisps of hair and skin stretched tightly over their bones. Ew. Others are fresher. A few old short swords lie on the dusty floor.
Gee, I wonder what's going to happen.
Don't try to loot them.
That.
Hey, Kroll, go check them for gold.
Yeah. Yeah, I like it.
Nice. There's 12 corpses in here. 7 are skeletal and 5 are fresher type of corpses.
I got mixed feelings. I have mixed feelings about this room.
Okay, so what do you guys want to do? Oh, somebody rolled something.
Try sneaking in.
You can try sneaking in. 16 is good enough to sneak in. So you get in there, and you're amongst, you know, they're all kind of leaned up against the walls and whatever, like I said. And there's nothing, you know, nothing attacks you or anything. They're all just kind of there. It doesn't look like anything's weird or anything.
Okay. Oh, cool to let everyone know. It's okay then.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know about that, because as soon as one of us makes a wrong move, we're going to be surrounded. So, what the fuck are we doing in that room?
Getting ready to get surrounded. Or not.
Well, just depends on what you guys want to do.
If we do anything and we sort of stir up the hornet's nest, we need to keep them at a choke point. So we need to back out of this tunnel.
Alright. Was there anything else in this room? Or was it just...
There's nothing else in there that I didn't describe.
But then, there's not really any point to be in there, so...
That's up to you.
Now, I'm not a fan of leaving enemies behind me. So, if we want to stir up the hornet's nest, that's fine with me. I just want to get into a more defensible position at the mouth of this tunnel. So
move back and then I'll throw a rock at one of them then.
Exactly. So let's get in a little more defensive position so only like one of them can come at us at a time. And then, you know, we'll slap the hornet's nest with a stick or whatever.
I like it.
Folks,
we're doing all this and they're probably going to be dead anyway. Are we cool here, or are we moving further back? Oh, you
I would,
want to move
yeah, I would
back
come
there?
To where I'm at and have me and Kroll post up here in the front, blocking the cave entrance.
Oh, wait, I need to go over. Why let someone else aggro than them?
How are you going to do anything to them if we're all the way over here?
Yeah. That's what I mean. Okay, I'll move back over there, and then I'll throw a rock, and then I'll run back. Can I do that?
Yep, that's fine. Now, so at this point, who's doing what? I got you guys. All I was doing was just approving your moves. I just kept approving everybody's moves.
Yeah, okay.
But what's going to happen now?
I'm going to throw a stone at one of the skeletons and see if anything happens.
Okay, you throw a stone, and nothing happens.
Go hit one.
I throw another
fist.
One just to. Alright, I'll. I try and hit one of the ones with more flesh on them.
With a stone?
No, with the maul.
With your maul?
Yeah.
Okay, so you, you get a little bit of a. Like a. Like, hey, is that dead body early dead? You get a little tap with the maul, like push on it?
We've been fooled once.
Yeah, you have, but, touching the corpse with the maul does nothing. Nothing happens. It's all
smack
quiet
it.
And all.
Hit it. Hit it hard.
Chop off the head. Chop off the head.
Very brave comments from the guys way out in the other room.
Okay, I'll hit it with the maul then. Like, properly.
Okay, you smack it with the maul and nothing happens.
Well, alright, just take them all out then.
I'll take them out one by one.
Well, if you go around the room whacking them, it's just the same result. If you just whack on them,
that, or
they're just yeah, they're not they don't animate or anything. But
he's reading DM notes.
I'm done. I know what's supposed to happen or not happen. But
you know what? I know what got us last time. I tried to take one of their I searched their pockets for gold.
There you go. Just like fill them all up. See what happens.
Yeah.
Some more.
So yeah, just tell me what you... Oh, I didn't have my push to talk down during that whole thing. I was... well, it doesn't matter what I said. But yeah, just tell me what you want to do.
I'm going to try and loot them.
You're going to try and loot a skeleton or a body?
All of them.
Okay.
Like, I need a wishbone here.
As you touch something, everybody roll initiative.
Yay, there we go.
So hitting them with the big hammer...
Hitting them with the big
nothing.
Hammer did nothing.
Of course.
It specifically says that. It specifically says you have to touch them.
Right. Oh, that's not good.
22. Okay, so... Zook, it's your turn.
Okay, I can move 25 feet.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to run out of there anyway. It might not be worth going in there.
Yeah, he can survive a couple rounds. I would actually not go up there.
So I haven't approved it yet. Do you want
to... Yeah, if he shouts, then I don't want to do that. Can I cancel it?
You can
somehow?
Cancel it. Yeah, pick your token up and just put it back down right there.
Then I ready action. As soon as I see one coming here, I want to cast a spell on him. Shitty touch.
Okay, already sucks. As soon as you see one come in range, that's what you want to do?
Yes.
Okay.
Every skeleton rolled a higher initiative than I did.
You'll be fine.
Oh, God. I wanted to help you, but you refused, so...
Well, I figured by the time you got to
You'll
me,
be fine.
Be... Okay.
Oh, my God, this is not... Okay, hold on.
If not, it was nice knowing you.
Had a
okay,
good run.
So Zook has his readied action, so pass your turn.
Okay.
Skeleton number two. Bing, bang, bong.
Time to do some of that rage shit.
That's what I'm thinking.
Okay, skeleton number two. Has,
doesn't notice me.
Is targeting Kroll, and...
No kidding.
He has a short sword that he's going to swing at you. He stands up, by the way. I'm assuming these guys are all prone, but he stands up. And he hits you...
You'll be fine.
...for 4 damage. And that's all he does.
Mm.
So, Bosco.
This is kind of hard, because I know what's going to happen to him. I'm going to go...
He rolled a 7 initiative.
I'm going to go here. Do I have line of sight from that space for a crawl?
Target the guy that you want. Actually target him.
Oh right, you're gonna heal me.
No, you're targeting him? No.
Because what I wanna do is I'm gonna ready an action with that movement. The next person that hits him, I'm going to heal him.
Oh, you're playing it all smart.
Yeah, because he hasn't taken a ton of damage yet, but on the next hit, I'm going to cast my healing word.
Healing what?
Yeah, healing word. It's got a 30-foot range.
Okay, so you got a movement and ready to action.
And that's my turn. So, can I end it, or...?
Yeah.
Okay.
Lyadin. Moves up.
I wasn't done moving, I was trying to plot it.
Okay, no problem, you got 10 more. Or whatever, is your movement 30?
Yeah.
Yeah, you got 10 more.
Because what I foresee is they're all going to move up on him, and if he tries to move away, he'll provoke all attacks of opportunities.
No, he can disengage.
He can disengage.
Lyadin, you're not in a square there. Can you change that to be in one or the other? Okay.
Guess I'm not escaping then.
You can move through,
you can move
spaces.
Through friendly spaces, yeah.
Okay.
You just can't end your turn. You.
Really? I thought this can only do a
hostile. No, you can move. You cannot move through hostile spaces unless you're 2 sizes different than the thing, or you can move through friendly spaces, but you cannot end your turn there. Okay, so he's moved. Is he going to do anything else?
Yep. So I'm going to drop my swords again and draw my crossbow.
Okay. Direct line of sight, no modifiers. You may fire when ready, sir. Yeah, 22. Bitch-ass skeleton. Okay, you hit him. Good job. He's hurting. He's sucking high tit right now. That would be a move. That would be an action. Anything else? Skeleton 11. He's ready. What's he gonna do? I'll tell you what he's gonna do. He's gonna move up. First guy he sees. Get her done. And miss.
Yay.
Good job. Skeleton 5, all in the back and crazy crap like that.
Bob and weave, man. Bob and weave.
Skeleton 5 will pull out his short bow.
Ah, that's lame.
And hit a... So Kroll has been hit, at which point the readied action of Healing Word...
Yeah.
Comes. And bam, he instantly has 7 points back. Nice. And is in fact... That was pretty sweet. Okay, he's gonna be done. Stupid skeleton. Kroll. It is your chance to run if you like.
No. I need to select it. Gonna bash it. No, I'm not. Never mind.
Skeletons are not as lame as zombies. The Raven is keeping watch, yes?
Yes.
Okay, so Zook.
You block me. I'm moving. I can use a dash action, exactly.
Yeah, you can move again if you'd like, but then you won't be able to do anything else. Unless that's some sort of bonus power you have or whatever.
Nope. Yeah. I lose a dodge action.
Dodge, okay. Sounds good.
Yeah.
If that's it, end your turn. Skeleton 2. Gonna redo his short sword. Oh, fumble! Oh, he critically fumbled! The next melee or range attack to hit you during this battle is a crit damage. Do not roll on the critical hit table. Okay. So whoever hits him next gets automatic crit.
Oh, nice.
Stupid skeleton. Okay, Bosco.
Is that a legitimate movement?
That is completely legit.
Okay. And then I'm going to roll to hit.
I wonder if there is a... hold on a second.
I don't know what skeleton that is. It's the red one.
That would be 11.
11? Okay.
Yeah, the one that I fucked up.
Oh, hold on a second. Hold on.
Oh, my bad.
That's okay. That's cool. I'm doing something here because I don't know how to apply an effect to make the hit on the other guy an automatic zombie, or an automatic crit. I know that you can do it. I just don't know how to do it, so we'll just have to remember that. Okay, what'd you do?
Go to the modifiers and drag the critical to him.
Yeah, I tried that. It wouldn't work.
How about dragging the critical to the player?
It'll allow you to drag effects, but it will not allow you to drag modifiers, which is fucking lame. All right, that's it. I'm going to get my $200 back. Fuck this game. No, I was kidding. No, this game is so really cool. So you hit him. Go ahead and roll your damage. Oh, he's dying.
Yeah, good job.
Where is he? Here he is.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
They don't have that zombie shit where they automatically come back.
Do you see that? It did 16.
It did crit, yeah. It did 16.
Yeah.
It tripled.
It crit him?
Yeah, do you see? Like, I rolled an 8, but it says damage 16.
You might have put that on the wrong one. Wasn't it the one that's next to me that was getting the crit thing?
Yeah, so it did work, Rob. You just put it on the wrong the wrong skeleton.
Oh, yeah. Hey, thanks, Jake, by the way. Jake's in the chat, Jaconian. He's a guy. And he's telling me grant attack or grant advantage. Yeah, which is in my... It's just so stupid. I should know that. Now, wait a minute. Let's back up a second here. So I had it on the wrong guy.
Yeah, the one that's next to Crew is the one that was meant to get the crit thing.
Correct.
I'm not sure what one that is, though.
But why did it do... it didn't...
When you drag the modifier for critical, did you put it on skeleton 11 by mistake?
No, I put it on, or I tried to put it on skeleton 2, but it wouldn't let me do it. But how you do that, Jake just reminded me how you do that is you, you go like this. You give him that effect, grant advantage attack, and that will.
That makes it an automatic crit.
Yeah, David, are you in the chat window for Twitch or no?
I am.
Okay, so you're okay. Yeah.
Just the chat. That's it.
Right. Yeah. That's cool. So handle that for me because I just looked over and I saw my buddy Jake saying all this crap and I didn't even he doesn't even know I'm not even looking at it. So, what's up, Jake? Okay, so but this damage that you rolled against skeleton 11, it said hit damage, bludgeoning 1d8. So you did that damage to skeletons.
Oh, are they vulnerable to bludgeoning damage?
They are vulnerable.
That's why.
So it gave him double damage because they're vulnerable, right?
Right.
Okay, so that's why. So the crit thing didn't happen. However, that has been adjusted, so that will happen automatically next time. And thanks again to Jake for reminding me how to do that. Okay, so Bosco has moved. He has attacked. Has he got anything else up his sleeve? No, Liadin is
okay, ready so to kick my question ass. Is, with Skeleton 2, the next hit's going to be an automatic critical, but the syntax grant advantage to attack makes it an automatic critical or gives him automatic advantage?
Let me make sure I did that right. Grant advantage attack is what he says here. Grant advantage attack. Yeah. He's granting you advantage on an attack.
That's not what the fumble did, though.
What did it do?
The fumble makes the next attack that hits an automatic critical.
Oh, you're right. You're right. Yeah, see, I'm out of my mind. Okay, so in that case, roll your attack, and then if it hits, we'll make the damage critical, which I know how to do.
All right, so I'm going to drop the crossbow and pick up my swords.
Okay.
And then move.
Okay. And you're going to attack number 2, right?
That is correct.
Okay, go for it. And it is, in fact, a hit. So now just apply the crit modifier to your damage roll.
And all I have to do that is just click critical to where it turns red and then roll the damage?
Exactly. I think you killed him, and are you trying to attack him again?
Yeah, I don't know if he was dead or not, so I was just following
through.
Yeah,
he's dead, so you can take that back.
Okay.
So... Why didn't it...
He's like, no death saving.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. He's not dead. Crap. I see this window screwing me up. The signifier It's too hard to explain to you guys. I made a mistake and removed his effect. I thought he was dead, so I removed his effect. So we'll have to keep that in mind. But you do get your second attack, which did hit. So go ahead and do your damage, and let's just... It'll probably end this guy anyway.
And this is just regular damage for this attack,
This
right?
is regular damage, yeah. Yeah, good. He's dead. Makes it easier. Scratch one skeleton. Okay. Who's next?
Well, Skeleton 11 is dead too, right?
Yeah, Skeleton 5 left.
No, Skeleton 11 is dying.
Yeah, he's... I usually try to take them off right away. If you guys kill somebody and I don't take him off, just please remind me to do it. But did he die like last turn or something?
Yeah, the Shillelagh killed him.
Oh, right on. Okay, so is that the end of your turn?
Yep, sorry.
Okay, so it's him. He's still going to stick with the crossbow action. But he's switching to Lyadin. Shortbow, I mean, not crossbow. And he misses. And he just stands there because he's an idiot.
Okay. Gonna run over there. And I'm gonna use my move.
You see what I put in there, Rob?
In the Twitch or the... No, I don't see whatever it is.
No. Oh, in chat, Jake just said
to
try the attack critical thing. I don't know what that means, but it may mean something to you.
Okay, I'll...
He just made the syntax, put in attack, colon, crit.
Is that you put it for the PC or you put it for the... See, he's also texting me, but I can't... It's making me crazy. He can do this. He DMs and he's watching TV, he's eating cereal, he's talking to his girlfriend, he's making texts, he's emailing people, and he's playing the game, and he's doing everything. And he's all on top of it. But I get overwhelmed. But I wonder if he means, Jake, do you mean that you put it on the character and his attack is critical, or do you put it on the monster and it attacked... colon critical will make the next attack against him critical. That's what I need to know. Okay, so Cruel, what's going on?
Oh, I just one-shot the skeleton. I, ran over and crushed him into dust.
Oh, well, that's fantastic. I missed it. Okay, he's dead. Yeah, I see it. I'm looking now. You mauled him.
I did.
All right, good job, guys. Okay, so now I need to put that in your experience. Don't want to forget that. That's a very important part.
Go touch one of the zombies.
I mean, they're down now, right? There's no more left?
No more zombies.
But we can loot them.
You can loot the
Definitely
zombies.
Definitely safe this turn.
They have nothing.
Oh. Never mind.
But you should always loot. Okay, so... there is nothing else of significance in this room. You guys are pretty much done in there. To make it easy, I'll just move you guys all back out there. And the map is really super inflated for me, so I might not put you on an exact square, but I'll fix that in a second. And you guys can now, move accordingly to where you want.
Oh, should we wait to heal up, or do
you
want to
you don't want to go too much further before you decide what you want to do in regards to that.
I mean, I'm happy to carry on if you guys are.
Yeah, I think we're still pretty good.
Yeah, we're good.
Yeah, I think we're okay. I still got my second win. Cruel's got most of his HP. I'm sure he probably got a couple spells left.
Cool.
Okay, so let me back out here a second here. Let me show you guys what you see down there.
I need to remove the effect on me, the rage one.
Okay,
Balls, you're still targeting Cruel, by the way.
Oh.
Yeah,
sorry
don't.
About that.
Oh, yeah, actually,
sorry
put,
about that,
put,
yeah.
No, put that back on. I was going to test something. Put that attack on him. Yeah, I want to see something here.
I don't like where this is going.
No, nothing that's going to kill anybody. Hold on.
That room really was useless then, wasn't it?
Okay, I cleared the initiatives,
XP,
but
bro.
It did not take off the target. So yeah, go ahead and remove that. I just wanted to see if that would do that automatically.
That's how I look at it, man. Closer to level 2.
Yay.
Okay, so. Let me get a handle on this map. The Raven's going down there.
So, Zook, does this look like your home?
Totally.
Okay, so let me open this up a little bit more. You guys can see stuff.
Do gnomes ever paint the walls in their caves?
They put all fancy tape stereo on the wall.
Okay, so let's see. You guys are coming down the way here. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Stupid thing. Stupid. Okay, I think, I have some stuff to tell you then. Okay, so on the way down, what I guess in this case would be south, is that not true?
Yep.
I see a bunch of language stuff going on in there in the chat, that looks cool. This narrow passage is about 10 feet high. In most places, with rough, irregular walls, protruding spurs on the walls are coated in dried blood. Yeah, that's probably not any good, is it? Eventually, it widens out, and I'll open up the map, and but this is what you guys see when you look down there. The star-shaped cavern ahead has many clefts in its walls. Only two across the cavern seem large enough to traverse. Three zombies lurch about the area. One is costumed like a bear, another one dressed like a lady in a frilly dress and thick makeup, and the last is costumed in a jester with a jingling bells on its collar and sleeves.
Yeah, this is my kind of party.
Yeah, what's going on here?
Yeah. So let me open
it up.
A
weird
here.
Blood orgy.
Yeah, zombie furries.
So that's the cavern that you see, and those zombies are there. You see them even before you get there. So let me fix that. At this point, everyone can roll initiative.
Ooh.
Okay. And we'll let that bird get up. So, just one second. Okay, so the zombies are in there, and I'm finding out what else might be happening. Hmm. Okay. Interesting. Sorry about this, guys. This is, like, super involved about this happens or this doesn't happen and this kind of thing. Okay, yeah, I wish Area L5. I wish I knew where that was. Sorry, guys.
No worries.
And I certainly did close that other map. Wow, okay. It's just crazy over here. I'm closing all kinds of windows. I really did have, like, maybe 12 windows open. Ah, here we go. Okay. Okay, so you guys see those zombies in there. They haven't spotted you yet. So at this point, it's totally like, what do you guys want to do?
Shoot one with my crossbow.
Yeah.
Well, maybe we should shoot him. Sneak up to them.
I can hit him from here.
Yeah, but at the moment, isn't it going to be difficult for everyone to hit them?
Yeah, Kroll's in front. We'll be fine.
Okay, so who said they wanted to shoot somebody with a crossbow?
I don't know. What do you think about that, Kroll?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so whoever, I'll let that be the first action, whoever you want to target.
Oh, before we go into combat, can I get my javelin out instead of my grey axe?
Well, we're in combat, but yes, you can get get your javelin out. That's allowed. That's a free action to change weapons. But if you have your you'd have to drop your axe. You can't just
I can pick it up and attack in the same turn, right?
Yeah, remember, I'll say this again. You can interact with one object for free. So dropping something doesn't count, but picking something up does. So you really can't touch two weapons in the same turn unless one of them is you're dropping it, which I'm not really counting as touching it. But do you understand? You can't manipulate two different weapons in the same turn.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So but if you drop your axe to get your javelin out, that's fine. And then if you throw the javelin, next turn you could pick up the axe. That's not a problem.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so who's firing the crossbolt or whatever's happening?
Me.
Say your character's name. I still don't have the voices all down.
Leiden.
Leiden. Okay. So let's see. Let me find the. Okay, so we're going to put it on your turn, and then I'm just going to do it that way for this time, and we'll just work with it. So go ahead and fire away. I'm assuming you're shooting at the one you can see.
So is there nothing special about the fact that they're all dressed up? Special enemies.
Well, they're zombies, so obviously they were those people before they died. I mean, you know, that's what I would think anyway.
Oh, I had it in my head that they'd gone into disguises.
No.
Right, okay. That makes more sense.
Okay, so he puts a crossbow into the. Oh, by the way, you guys have been keeping track of your ammo, yes?
Yep.
Okay, so anybody that's firing ranged weapons needs to keep track of your ammo, because you have a chance to get some of it back. after it's all over. Okay, so did you want to move at all, Lyodin?
Well, since this took place, yes, technically at the beginning of combat, since I'm firing, but up to that point, it was all kind of like freeform. So would I be able to drop my crossbow and pull out my swords?
Yes.
And after I fire that shot, that's what I'll do. And then after this is resolved, I'll go back and get my crossbow from this position.
Okay. But you don't want to move at this point? Oh, okay, you do. Wait, two people moved. What happened? I need to have the lines are overlapping. I'd be okay with it normally, but the lines are overlapping, so I need you guys to take that back and just lie it in.
No, one of my lines is me targeting the zombie.
Oh, it is? Oh, wow. Okay, well, that sucks. Let's do that then. Okay, there you go. Okay, Zook.
I am okay.
Shouldn't it go from the top of the initiative order?
I had like a roll of one.
Well, you're right, but what I did was I rolled initiative and then I took your action, and then I'm starting there. But that's how we're gonna do it because you didn't really surprise them. They saw you there, but they, you know, I'm just doing it that way. That's just how I set it up. So.
I want to move as soon as possible.
By the way, that's when a character says I'm going to shoot them, and we haven't even done anything yet or whatever. That's totally awesome. That's initiative. I mean, that's initiative not in the D&D sense, but in the real world sense. That's cool. That's proactive and everything. But that's the result you get is, you know, the characters that rolled a 21 and 19 for their initiative this turn, they get skipped. So that's just how it's going to be. So. But it's still to your guys' advantage because you're gonna get, you know, you're gonna get 1, 2, 3 or at least, well, we don't count the Raven, but you're gonna get 2 attacks on these things before they even get a chance to move. So, sorry, Zook, go ahead. I'm gonna improve your move. And if you guys wanna, the other thing I like to do, Jake taught me this, is we, you know, we'll be done here in a little bit, probably sometime around 4, probably after this battle. And then after we're done, if you guys have any like concerns or questions or suggestions about the rules and stuff, I'm totally open to listening to that. So, like, we can talk about the initiative thing and stuff too, but after we're done. Okay, what happened? You're targeting, you're rolling, you're hitting, you're killing. What's happening?
Yeah, I'm moving zero and then the cost.
Everybody just calm down.
Everybody just relax.
And then cast Chill Touch on the injured zombie.
Okay, and you hit him, so that's good. Do your damage. Oh, well, he's done, isn't he? Nice.
Sweet. And that ends my turn.
Okay, and the Raven's not going to do anything?
Nope.
So, Bosco. Bosco P. Coltrane. Push to talk.
No, I know. I was just looking at my range indicator. I gotta move extra range because I'm too far back.
Okay, so you're gonna move and then dash or whatever?
Right.
Okay. Right on.
Do I see anything else now that I can see the whole room?
No, there's just those two zombies.
Actually, can I dash this way? I don't want to block anyone from being able to get inside.
Okay. Do me a favor, though. Roll a perception roll.
You notice that the zombie dressed up like Lady has blonde hair.
Yes, that. And you did happen to see down the southwest corridor, just out of your view, just going away out of your view, which would actually be, I think, toward the top. This damn map. Hold on a second. So right there where I have the red arrow pointing, just as you got up there, you saw a dude. You couldn't even really make him out. You just saw a dude, like, running down that hallway. You don't even really know, like, what's up.
Wow.
We can just expect an ambush from that direction.
So...
maybe he's friendly.
Yeah, he's come to give me a hug.
Oh, he saw you and ran,
so... he was running away.
Yeah, he's running away. Krull, you're up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna pick up my axe again.
Okay.
And... I mean, I guess I'll run over there. Wait, actually, okay. Could I have... I couldn't have gone into range of any of them, could I?
Not really. I mean, the square that is, like, you know, down and to your right, you couldn't really get in that square because it's got too much stuff in it.
So, I picked up my axe. I'm able to...
wait a minute, where were you? Yeah, see, this is why I like to have the paths drawn out, because were you just down and to the right of Zook?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, so...
I think a bit behind me, one thing. One square.
I mean, I was in that general direction.
You could make it to that square if you wanted to.
Oh, okay. Yeah, in that case, I'll just use my maul then.
Okay, so go for it.
Rage!
I've already used it. I don't think I can use it again, can I?
What's the... I don't know, is it per day?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you get so many times per day or per long rest or something.
Oh,
Yeah, but we haven't had, we haven't rested since he raged, right?
No, we haven't.
Right, so you wouldn't get it back. Okay, so, he gets hit, right on.
Pretty disappointed with my roll so far. Oh, I need to...
okay, anything else?
Nope, end of my turn. The zombie 12.
Zombie 12.
According to the rage table, you can rage twice before you need to rest.
Okay, right on.
Oh, okay.
So you can turn that on later if you want. And it's perfectly fine. Like, you know, I know you guys are new, and like I didn't even know that, so it's always good to look up stuff.
But there must be it goes up somewhere. As he levels. So level 1 and 2, he can do it twice, and then 3 times when
is
he's
that,
you know, 3rd, 4th, and 5th.
Per rest or per long rest?
I think it was per
once you have rage, the number of times shown for your barbarian level in the rages column, you must finish a long rest before you can rage again.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's see. Zombie 12... is going to step up. Target Krull. Do the slam attack. And for a whopping 3 damage. And he's done. Zombie 7. All kind of pissed off, but not really because they're kind of stupid. Don't even really know. Who just got hit by you. Slam!
Smash. Ah, come on.
Just roll min. And it is Lyadin. He moves. He targets. He lashes out in a furious... night. Second attack. Good times. Zook. He moves. He looks around. He's chilling with a touch.
Nice.
Yeah. Good times.
So, this raven isn't very useful. What other choices did you have?
It can't attack.
It can't. Yeah, it can't attack.
But however,
familiars could you?
Sounds like a chicken.
It can be used for your touch spells, though, Zook.
Right. It can.
I don't have any.
Not anymore. It can also. Well, it can be used for the point of. It can be used for point of spell origin. So it can also do ranged spells, I believe. But
yeah.
He only
has
one spell.
Any. Yeah, I only have one spell.
Wait, okay. So you could use it to cast around a corner?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Bosco's producing flames. And he's doing damage.
Seems weird that a druid casts flames.
Well, you can make it in your mind.
It is one of the elements.
It's fire!
Yes.
I need control over fire so the forest doesn't burn down.
Ah.
Smokey the Bear.
Okay, so... attack, move, anything else?
That thing that's in the hallway is gone, right?
It took off, yeah. You can't really,
Okay, I just
you can see,
a little bit
you can see a little bit down further, but it's just empty hallway.
Okay.
How about that?
Cruel.
That's what I'm talking about.
I'm just getting
serious
worst rolls.
Alright, zombie 12, if you're done.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, Zombie 12 is still got his main attacker there. They don't change their mind. And he misses. What in the hell? What the hell? Oh, yeah, it's a critical miss. Like, I saw that shit. I'm like, what did I break it? I broke it. Fumble! Staggering in pain, your opponent parries your awkward attack and causes you to hit yourself in the groin. You have
zombie
a half movement and are stunned for one round. If this action is impossible, your origin target receives advantage on his next attack. Okay, I'm going to make this guy stunned. That's fucking awesome. Holy shit, that was cool.
What does it mean by, what was it? If this action is impossible, is that like if they don't have a groin?
There
like,
are
yeah.
some, well, yeah, or right. Like, yeah. But, and there are some creatures that cannot be stunned.
Like an ooze cannot be stunned, for example.
Oh, so it's not the groin part that was impossible, it's the stun part.
Oh, wow. Everything has a groin. Everything.
That's cool.
Right, okay.
All I did was, yeah, I clicked on stunned and it gave it stunned. Nice. Okay, so he is stunned and also done. Zombie 7. And he misses.
At this point, I'm looking like a bit of a badass. Like, carried one.
Which one is stunned? 12? Which one's that?
12 is the...
it's the one...
one on
the
left.
On the left.
Oh, good. Just gonna step to the side there.
Oh, sorry about that.
Now, with him being stunned, does that give me any sort of advantage?
It will give you advantage. It will give you the proper, you don't have to make any adjustments. You just roll your
head.
It'll do it. It's all automatic, yeah. Yeah, see, it gave you advantage. Nice. Yeah. He's dead. Awesome. Uh-oh, hold on. Gotta make a save. He's not gonna make that. Wait, why didn't it work? Hold on. Friggin' map.
So, do I get any kind of bonus for attacking them with a bludgeoning weapon, since they're zombies?
Zombies?
No. I think zombies are maybe vulnerable to slashing. I'm not sure.
Slashing? Okay, it seems weird.
Whoever wants to know that information, roll nature.
Oh. Okay.
A 20. Okay. I'll tell you that, Liadin, you know this, and you can tell your other party members, if you so choose, which I'm assuming you would, that zombies are immune to poison, and that is it.
Gotcha. Note to party, we're immune to poison. Don't use it.
I
just put...
Also, Zombie 12 is dead. Oh, yeah, no, he did not make his con save. So yeah. he did
I
not
also
pop,
learned...
Did not pop.
Note
pop.
To party, Zombie 12 is dead.
Yes, that is true.
But you think bludgeoning would do more damage to a zombie than slashing or piercing?
Well, I mean,
headshot.
Not necessarily. It's all
not
the same.
Not necessarily. Like, okay. With a skeleton bludgeoning, you're actually, like, crushing bone, so.
Right, okay.
Okay, anything else from Liadin?
I thought I ended my turn. I guess I did not.
Zook.
I move forward and attack the last remaining zombie.
And you're attacking with what?
With Chilling Touch.
Okay, that's okay, go for it.
That's the only spell I have. And
oh,
I missed
it.
Oh,
so our good. First miss. Congratulations.
That was it.
And what was the effect that Chilling Touch gives you?
If it hits, the zombie gets disadvantage. For attacking.
Oh, right, only if it is. Okay, so it appropriately removed your effect and did nothing. Okay, cool.
Right. Yeah. It also prevents them from healing if they have some sort of regeneration.
Oh, that's
yeah,
nice.
But it says explicitly not for undead.
Oh, there you go. Okay, Bosco, he's coming with us too. Nice.
You almost had a 20.
Oh my god. Zook, we're in trouble, man.
Ooh.
We're in trouble. That's it, I'm done.
Troll.
Crush him.
Hammer time. Nope.
Oh, here we go.
My God, oh. What is this zombie made of?
Oh, you rolled on the critical table, and luckily you rolled a 1 and nothing happened to you.
And didn't chop off
so wait,
Lyden's
I rolled
head
a
or
1 twice in a row.
That's crazy.
That's really bad.
Okay, Zombie 7. He's back to his old tricks.
And he's going to kill me.
I don't know what Zook just said, but I'm assuming he's talking shit.
He fumbled again! Holy shit! Well, he throws his weapon, but he does not have a weapon. He's doing a slam attack. So in that case, that's just simply a miss for him. But that's
just
too
he throws his hand.
He's got another hand. But he's totally done. He'll be dead in a second anyway. So
yeah, I don't know what Zook is saying in that language. I'm assuming he's talking shit.
I'm swearing till I missed.
You guys are talking orc to each other and shit. Okay, I can see all that, but I haven't been reading it. But I did read that.
All right, Lydon's gonna move up.
Okay.
Wow.
Oh no, not again.
What is going on?
Oh, somebody's prone.
Can I attack when I'm on the ground?
You can.
The chances that everybody would
this is...
screw up.
Yeah, but it's not just screwing up, it's critical screw ups, too.
Alright, well, I still got half my movement left, so can I stand up?
You can.
Okay, I'm gonna do that.
Okay,
pushing it back down.
Okay, so Zook.
Yeah,
I believe
same
in
again.
You, man. I believe
totally.
This battle took a turn for the worse.
This is probably the one that's dressed as a gesture, not a gesture, but a jester.
Here it comes.
He's dressed just as dancing a jester. Around in circles, a big metal finger.
Hand first.
Yeah. Oh my god, yeah, a hit! Holy shit! Yes.
You better kill it.
Critical. Not dead.
Ooh. What?
Okay, any movement out of you,
yeah.
Zook?
Nope.
Okay. Bosco.
Okay, don't worry, I'll miss it.
Hit.
Hey!
Oh! Hey! Alright, yeah. Let's roll his save. Let's roll his save.
And he's back.
Friggin' zombie.
Wait, is he alive again? It's my turn.
He is. He just popped back up.
I don't believe it.
Hold on.
I'm trying to get better about ending my turn when I'm done. So that's why I just went ahead and skipped.
Ah, okay.
Okay, he is, oh, wait, hold on, wait, don't go yet.
Oh.
Well, you would have hit him.
Is ready to end this shit.
You would have hit him anyway. He's actually prone. I needed to make that effect on him, but you would have hit him anyway, so that's fine, just do your damage. Well, no, I mean, I'm sure he's dead now. Yeah, and he can't pull that crap again. All right, good job,
I just
gentlemen.
I crushed his head with my hammer.
Let me let me put that experience in before I forget.
How do you do that, Rob? Well, I'll ask you after the game's over.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so you guys, bam! Everybody's got 113 experience points.
What do we need to level 2?
300.
Oh, we leveled.
No, we leveled.
No, you need 300. You have 113,
oh,
so you're about a third of the way
there. Oh, so
that's
450.
Yeah, it's a 450 divided by 4.
Ah, it's a
right, okay.
If you guys, on your character sheets, only Liadin has done this at this point, but on your character sheets on the front page, next to, what is it, your class, or, where is it? Let me find it before I start spouting off here. Yeah, at the end of your class and level, there's a magnifying glass.
Mm-hmm.
You can open that, click on that and open it up, and you can, it says next level 0, Liadin already has his filled, but you can put 300 in there.
Oh.
And that way you'll know. It doesn't do anything for the automation, and when you hit 300, it does not level you up. It's just a signifier for you to know. Because when you level up, how you actually do that, when we hit second level, you'll just go to your class in the player's handbook and drag in the same, you'll drag in wizard or drag in druid or whatever it is, and it'll make you second level, and it'll add all the appropriate shit that you get. Pretty cool.
Yeah, cool.
So, well, at this
I
point...
I thought you had to do everything manually.
No, you drag it in, baby.
So if I'm a fighter, I just drag in fighter again, and it'll make me level 2.
It'll change you to fighter 2, and it'll give you all the appropriate extra level shit that you get, and it'll add your hit points and everything.
Are you also able to do the multiclassing thing? Like, drag a different class into your...
Yeah, if you're multiclassing, you just do the same thing. You just drag, like, if you're a wizard and you're going to multiclass into fighter, you just drag fighter in. If anybody's multiclassing, they need to talk to me about that. You just have to meet the requirements. Okay, so at this point, gentlemen, you guys have all done. You had 4 battles. You crushed everything. Zombie skeletons. You don't give a shit. You crush shit. I think I'm going to call it for the day.